Gary, do you want Casey to tell the story? I don't know what the story is, but Gary said this is something happened to Casey yesterday, and we got to talk about it on the air. And would I trust him to just bring it up?
Yeah.
What is it?
You know, he's an amazing guy because
then I want to read about Ann Haitch and Ellen DeGeneres. I got a great article on that.
Casey's an amazing guy because you would think that he would recognize this right away as a great story for the air.
Hmm.
And he's telling me yesterday, and he's asking me if this ever happened to me.
Okay.
So he says, listen, man, because something weird happened.
Where is he? Is he not going to tell?
He's coming down. I'd rather tell you than he can.
All right.
You fill in the blank.
Because something weird happened to me.
He goes, something weird happened. He goes, I'm laying in bed with my girlfriend, and I had a—I'll say it the best way I can—I had an accident, a number one accident,
mm-hmm.
all over the bed,
laying in bed.
Yeah.
He wasn't asleep.
Awake.
He was asleep.
He was asleep.
He was asleep. And he basically
went to bed.
He went to bed.
No.
And And he said
the accident wasn't a sexual.
No. He was asleep and he went to bed. And at one point he said he nudged his girlfriend and he said, you know, I think I went to bed. And she goes, you know what? I'm not in the mood for your stupid jokes right now, because I guess he's always kidding around.
Mm.
And he didn't. And have you ever went to bed as an adult?
Never as a child or as an adult.
Oh, I did as a child.
Yeah. I thought you had to. Never.
No, I never went to bed.
Oh, that was a problem with your other.
Yo, Howard,
used to mess up your underwear. Sorry.
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. I never did it in bed, though, Robin.
And Casey, the first thing I asked him was, was he drinking? And he goes, no, I don't drink during the week.
Dude, what happened? You were laying in bed, you were asleep?
I think I'm losing my mind, man. I was sleeping.
Because you know what? This guy's nuts. He tells me this is the scariest part of the bachelor party. People think it was Benji. It wasn't. This guy, I'm trying to talk to him. I even talked to Ralph about this. I said, you know, I tried to talk to Casey at the bachelor party, and the guy's just uncommunicative. I was trying to hang with him like a regular guy. He goes, yeah. He was oddly silent. And then I said to him, why'd you leave the party so quick at the tournament? He goes, I get anxiety attacks.
Sometimes.
He told me, wait. He told me that one time.
What do you mean an anxiety attack? Hold on, I want to hear from you. What do you mean an anxiety attack? What happened at the bachelor party?
I get these thoughts where I have to leave where I am. Like one time I was in I was looking at apartments.
Yeah.
Right? And I get these really weird thoughts. Like, it was a strange guy. I didn't know the guy. So I was looking to rent his place.
Mm.
And I got this thought that he had put something in the air that he was immune to, that somehow he was poisoning me. You
okay.
know what I'm saying?
And what about at the bachelor party? What were you thinking?
It's weird. It's like sometimes I feel like, you know, I can't really breathe, you know what I'm saying? And I just have to leave. It's like maybe I was poisoned or something like that.
Oh, you said someone put something in your drink?
Maybe. You know, it's one of those weird things. It's like, you know, I think I'm going to die.
He's paranoid.
He told me he checked himself into a hospital once.
Yeah, that was a weird thing.
Is that what you'd call that, a paranoid?
Yeah, well, he thinks somebody's trying to poison him.
He walked into it, but wait a minute. He walked into a house and thinks someone put poison in the air.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was a weird thought. And after, it's like, that can't happen. And it was really weird because I had a. I had a knife in my pocket, right? And I was like, you know what? I was grabbing at the thing. I was like, you know what? This guy didn't do anything to me, but I really have to.
You're going to end up killing somebody.
One of these days, you won't realize the dog isn't talking to you.
You know, why do you carry a knife?
Yeah, by the way, he went to Chicago to do an appearance, and he brought a knife with him, and didn't they stop you at the airport with the knife?
Yeah, but that's, you know what? They never stopped me before. I just had it in my pocket, and they.
You had a knife in your pocket, and they never stopped you.
Howard, it's a relatively big knife, and it's serrated, and the guys from Chicago...
How did you get through the metal detector?
They told me they were shocked that he got from New York to Chicago with it.
I've taken it all over.
Let me ask you a question.
The blade is not as long, but since
but
it's
is
jagged...
It, but when they, don't, they have, don't you have to empty your pockets when you go on the plane?
Yeah, and it's fine, because they have a measure to see how long the blade can be.
Huh?
And oh, my God. My mom once went traveling with me, and she brought an apple with her, and she likes to cut her apples, so she brought a little kitchen knife. They told her absolutely not. They confiscated the whole thing.
So no, that's because it's got to have it can have a straight edge, but it can't have a jagged edge.
That's
what they told me.
I never heard of this.
Because you could cut wires with it, I guess. But it's weird. They never stopped me before. Now they
why would you be bringing a knife on a plane?
It's just I have it in my pocket.
Do you carry it all the time?
Pretty much. Yeah, in my pocket.
Like for protection and stuff.
Well, it's just
so you're telling me when you were at the bachelor party. You started to think that someone was trying to, like, put drugs in your...
Maybe. It's something that all these, you know, these weird things you think.
What? Who would be there that's going to put
I have no idea, and that's the thing that drives me nuts.
Thank God you're good-looking. You'd never get a girl.
Why did you check yourself into a hospital? What was that incident?
I thought I was dead. I thought I was about to die, because I couldn't breathe.
Mm.
Dude,
you don't know you have problems?
I know I do. Now, this thing that happened the other night, I'm at my wit's end.
Did you wet the bed?
I couldn't believe it.
What do you... fully wet it?
Dude, I woke
up... What happened when your girlfriend woke up? Then you realized you wet the bed, because it might have smelled like urine.
Wow. No, I was like, you know, I tried to wake her up, and she said, I'm not in the mood for your jokes right now. And then,
some joke.
That could be a Casey joke.
Yeah. So then, eventually, I got up, and she... you know, she ran and I changed the sheets. Right?
How do you change it? Oh, when she got up.
See, I have those egg crates. You know what the egg crates are?
Yeah.
Underneath the bed that make it softer.
Oh, so the...
So it leaked down into that.
The mattress,
I had to rip that off and put the sheet on it. And she told me the other day that when she was walking back, she stepped on my wet underwear.
Oh!
Dude, I
still she's saying, Judy, you want any medication?
No.
He should be, Howard.
Go to a doctor?
You know, I was having anxiety attacks, Howard, and ever since I've been going to the therapist, I haven't had one in a while.
But what kind of anxiety attack do you have?
You know, he wound up in the hospital.
Yeah, I went in the hospital. I had an ambulance, like, bring me.
But what's wrong with you?
Because I you know, I couldn't breathe. I was having problems breathing.
Yeah, but maybe you got something wrong with you.
Wasn't that over monetary stuff?
Yeah, I was getting all stressed out.
Yeah, but Casey's delusional. He thinks people are trying to poison him.
That's crazy.
But now I realize, you know, they're not trying to poison me, but at the time...
But Howard, that's not... I mean, he's got a problem.
Dominic, what is
this
it?
This isn't simple.
Yeah, Dominic, what's up?
I want to ask Casey whether his mother or her brothers or her side of the family had an illness like this.
No, not at all.
No one ever had any hospitalizations?
No, nothing mental. No, I don't know what happened to me.
I don't know. His dad had a weird thing with him. Yeah. His dad was like a football coach or a wrestling coach and forced him to do stuff.
Yeah, but Dominic is looking for a hereditary
thing. I know. Like mental illness.
You got to assume that the peeing was some sort of way in his mind of saying he didn't want the woman there.
Oh, stop it.
Oh, come on. Get out.
No, but see, that's...
Not a bad point. That's like guys who smoke cigars.
Angle.
No, that's like guys who smoke cigars. They always go, you want to get chicks, and guys... That's
and
the biggest turnoff.
The biggest, smelliest thing you can think
that looks like a penis.
Did you ever, like, have a dream, and you kind of are tricked in your dream, like your mind is tricking you, to think that
no.
If you have to go to the bathroom, here's a toilet.
A million times I've had to go to the bathroom. I wake up all night going to the bathroom because I drink so much water, but I've never peed the bed.
I couldn't believe it. I have no idea what
that
means.
Were you dreaming of being in the bathroom?
No, but I remember as a kid, that's what used to trick me. That's when I...
Trick him. That used to trick you? Your own mind tricked you?
Yeah. And sometimes I'll wake up. No, so I told you this one day. Sometimes I'll wake up.
You got tricked by yourself.
He beat himself.
No, okay. And I don't know what time I'm supposed to get up.
Dude, you're like Ann Hage. Did you read this article? Well, guys, you got to listen to this. I
got
to read this to you.
Ann Hage right here.
Yeah. This is from the Seattle Times.
Okay.
More details are emerging about Ann H.'s Sunday adventure in Fresno. Note, we said details and not facts. What we know for sure, the day after she and Ellen DeGeneres announced their amicable parting, Ann had car trouble and was hospitalized after knocking on a stranger's door about a mile away and saying odd things.
Now, don't you get hospitalized when you have car trouble?
Wait, listen to this. So you don't know what odd things she said, right?
Right.
Fresno's NBC affiliate, KCTV, quoted a police report saying the actress, wearing only a bra, shorts, and shoes, told a deputy she was God and was going to take everyone to heaven with her on some sort of spaceship.
And they let her out?
Yeah. Wow.
She was only in the hospital an hour, Casey.
The person whose house Ann went to told the station she was saying a lot of funny things. She even put a pair of my slippers on, and she maybe put a pair of slippers on, too.
Let's all wear slippers.
Can you imagine inviting that into your house?
It sounds like the Cindy Margolis show.
Hey, it's a pajama party! Yeah! Pajama party! Ripkini! Ripkini! Woo! Hey, Scrib! You're hot!
The film's she's working on a film. The film's producer says... Wait. The Fresno Bee newspaper's website cited unnamed sources saying that she appeared to be under the influence of a substance, most likely the drug ecstasy. The film's producer says Anne's behavior was due to sunstroke. She was in a convertible and ran out of gas, so she was in the sun too long. Her neck and shoulders are still badly, badly burnt.
You know, you're embarrassed.
And whenever I get sunstroke, I think I'm gone.
And as weird as that story is, the second story on here is weirder. Woody Allen and Sun Yi Previn are parents again.
Yeah.
Boom, end the sentence.
No.
Woody 64 and Sun Yi 29 have adopted a second daughter. Anybody read the allegations? allegations? Me and Farrow?
I meant to ask you, really, how does he get a baby? Because
he's not going to.
But you have to be squeaky clean to go through any kind of agency.
You're a celebrity.
He's not going through an agency.
Yeah. Look how quickly Rosie got out kids, right?
Rosie never did anything wrong.
Who knows?
But they don't go to agencies.
Yeah.
Who knows? Who knows what goes on with these stations at the Four Seasons Hotel?
And Howard, you know what else is weird? You talk about people acting weird. Did you see that letter I have in front of you? One of our fans was arrested in San Diego. He was found naked running around a neighborhood saying he was Jesus Christ and Howard Stern.
Yeah, that was just in the paper.
Oh, no. Nobody we know, though.
No, no. They arrested a guy saying he was Jesus and Howard Stern.
But he's naked.
How did you know? Make up your mind.
Yeah. Well, if you were Howard Stern, you wouldn't be naked. Trust me. Bob, go ahead.
Hey, can someone please find a key to Casey's closet door and open it so he can get out, please?
Yeah, well, you get a point.
What the problem is.
That has nothing to do with it.
I think if you recognize your homosexuality.
I'm not homosexual. I just don't like guys.
What do you want to do?
Well, you don't have to like guys. I like penis. Go down to the store.
No, I don't find men attractive.
Something's bothering you, man.
Something's going on. You're awfully uptight about
Something's really bothering you, and if I was the reason you don't want to go to shrink, you're afraid to find out.
No, I would actually welcome it, but I've been there, and they're not going to help me, and they can't happen.
What can't happen? That he could help you?
I've been to a couple of them, and none of them ever helped.
You can be helped.
It's not just
probably in the boonies.
A social problem, Howard.
There's a psychological problem.
Yeah. Not even a there is a physical brain problem.
Something's out of whack.
Oh, really?
I think that he's much.
Maybe he's got a tumor.
You think he's bipolar?
That would be easy.
I think he's tri-pooler.
But you know what, Howard? Everyone's joking about Casey's gay. I genuinely don't believe he's gay, but I do believe that there's something that needs to be unlocked that would make him be much more normal. He needs to be freed of something.
Trust me. Send him down to the vault.
No, but there's something that's...
No, you don't need God. God's just another crutch.
Yeah, if you find that guy, I want to have a couple of questions with him. I want to sit down with him.
Oh, God?
Yeah. I got two questions I want to ask him.
Ask your questions.
You know, it could be simple. He could just be stupid.
What question do you... Wait a second. What question do you want to ask God?
Why he screwed everything up?
Yeah, go ahead, Rob.
Do you see anybody wound as tight as Casey, as young as he is?
No.
There's nothing in his life yet for him to be this upset.
I was trying to talk to him about his anxiety attacks, and he doesn't want to open up at all.
Something happened between him and his dad.
Oh, stop with that. You know, you sound like one of those strings.
No.
It's definitely
it's not stupid.
So have something to say, you know.
Dude, you're so programmed by your dad.
Been to jail for...
I'll ask you one question.
So angry.
How do you explain...
So you already went to anger management class.
How do you explain the whole touching thing?
You can't be touched.
That you can't be touched. You know about the rearview mirror on his desk, right?
No.
You know about this?
Oh, yeah. He put a rearview mirror in so no one can sneak up behind him.
Yeah, right. You try and sit there, be on the phone or something like that, and someone come over and tap you, which you're not expecting.
No, but that's being bothered. How one time,
no one has this character.
One time early on,
you try.
You should see his reaction when
he gets really mad.
I know, I pat him on the back a few times, he gets all freaky.
I did too, jumps out of his skin, I felt bad.
And he sits me down.
I don't mean to do it, but I just didn't know it was an issue.
His reaction when you touch him on the back is like as if you hid behind a door in a dark room and jumped out of it.
Yeah.
All right, John has a question for Casey. Go ahead, John.
Yo, Howard, how you doing?
All right.
Casey, I want to know if you ever crapped your pants, man.
Oh, yeah, I did.
About 5 minutes ago.
Well, anyway, he peed in his bed, and he wants everyone to know.
Can you believe that? Have you ever heard anything like that?
No.
Do you know anybody that's happened
to? Very sick people.
Yeah, no, you have a lot of issues and problems.
Is that a mental thing or is that physical?
Yes.
It's weak to see a psychologist.
Have you gone to a quality psychologist?
Obviously not.
Psychologist, psychiatrist.
No, psychotherapy.
He needs a
psychotherapist.
Brain
5 days a week.
That's what I went to.
Yeah.
Psychotherapy.
Where?
You went to a psychotherapist?
I went to one in Kentucky. I went to one here in Long Island.
Did you get plastic surgery done in Kentucky? Would you get plastic surgery?
Plastic surgery.
The guy in Kentucky, the barber, in his spare time.
Yes.
Kentucky. Dude, not even the United States.
When I was a kid, I went to one here.
Yeah, the school-appointed one.
Yeah. You never went to a quality guy.
No, see, that's been my plan for so far, but now, I'm going to try something new. Here it is. It's on the table.
What?
Do something.
Me?
No, I'm saying that. He said I never...
You should go... He hasn't opened up yet.
So now here it is. All right, what's going to happen?
Go ahead, open up.
I just did.
No, you didn't. You didn't say anything.
I told him I did the pants thing.
No,
tell me what you thought of your father.
He's a great guy.
Okay, what did he do to you? Tell everybody. Tell the truth.
What?
Want to open up?
He wanted me to do well in athletics.
Yeah.
I did.
And what did he do when he wanted you to do well in athletics?
Wait, who's my coach?
When you were on a football team and your dad was your coach.
Let me ask you something. Your dad was your coach.
When I got up to varsity, he retired so we wouldn't kill each other.
Right.
So what was wrong that he might kill you?
So don't you think there's a problem that your old man was sick, sitting there and pushing you?
No, that's
he's riding
no.
you.
No, that's because a parent that cares about his kid would want
to
do that.
All right, you got a lot to work
no,
on.
No, you don't believe that,
dude. You don't know
you're
what
not,
it's
you
like.
You support
what,
your kids and what they do,
Casey. What
he doesn't need to leave because he might almost kill them.
Right,
well, that's more me because I'm heavy.
My kids and I don't almost kill each other.
I got one for you, Howard.
Yeah. That's my take on it.
You think your dad should want to? You think he should be safe and protected with a father rather than someone who humiliates you and wants to kill you?
Who did that?
Your dad.
You just told
you don't know, man.
You told me a million times off the air.
I did not.
Here you go. What did you describe your summer every summer from the time you were a little kid till you were 18? What did you do every summer?
I went to wrestling camp.
What do you mean you went to wrestling camp?
What does that mean?
My family had a business.
All right. And what did your dad expect of you at wrestling camp?
I was going to wrestle.
And didn't you have to be the best?
Dude, you're not open enough. Yeah, I can't help you.
He was telling me that the day school ended, he had to pack up and go to wrestling camp, and they came back the day before school started, so he really didn't have summers. And then his dad would make him wrestle with the older kids because it would make him tougher. But also, he had to be there. Basically, he worked the whole summer.
Right. Your dad was so protective of you.
Well, I think that's it makes you mentally tough.
He thinks his dad, what his dad did for him, would make him a great wrestler.
No. He's
not.
Childhood.
He's sitting here with us. He's not wrestling.
Yeah, Joe, go ahead.
For that.
Joe, you're on the air.
You know, I feel so good about myself now, knowing that all you people have mental illnesses.
Well, Casey's already went into bed. It's getting serious.
I mean, he's a young
and he had to leave the bachelor party because he thinks people are trying to kill him.
I know. I think it's crazy.
He's losing his mind.
No, it's not that. It's happened once before when I was in college. I had one of these attacks or whatever, and then in the middle of it, I remembered they sprayed my dorm for bugs. I'm like, they poisoned me, the bugs. It was the spray. I inhaled the spray.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Listen to me. You want my advice? Seriously, run. Don't walk to a doctor. It's getting worse.
Go with Benji.
It is getting worse.
I used to hate people. I used to really hate them and want to injure them, but now I don't anymore. I really don't.
Right.
You still have a streak of that, though.
Howard, you guys are performing a public service.
Yeah.
You're
and
helping everybody
us
recognize.
Your report.
Casey's the gay guy in American Beauty. What do you think?
I think so.
Absolutely.
You're the next door neighbor?
Military man, yeah.
Hey, Howard, how about a laptop?
No. All right. We got to take a break. Casey, I hope everything's all right for you, but you really do need help.
Thanks, pal.
You want to kiss me?
Yeah.
You feeling like you want to kiss me?
I feel very open with you right now, and I want to hug you. And grab
Howard,
your hand.
Howard, who
even the way he talks, there's something wrong with even that voice.
Yeah.
Who is the most mentally stable person in this room right now?
This
whole
one.
Room. Who's the most mentally stable person? I look around the room, and I can't decide.
It's not you. No, Robin. You're very old.
I'm trying to think who could be.
I am the most mentally stable of this group.
No, you're not.
Oh, like absolutely.
You still don't see yourself.
I almost want to go with...
You're so wired.
I almost want to go with Jackie, but that's crazy.
No, you can't.
Jackie has a lot of problems.
You can't go with Fred.
You can't go with Fred. You can't
go
with you.
You can't go with you. You can't go with Robin.
Somebody.
I think Gary.
No.
No way.
No.
In this room, it's Gary.
Who's more mentally stable in this room than me?
Wait a minute.
Exactly.
I told you, it's me.
You're crazy.
Oh, Robin, you don't even see yourself.
I'm more
I'd probably say Jackie over Gary.
What's wrong with Gary?
Gary, while we're deciding, shouldn't you sneak out and have a cigarette?
No, I should just fund my wife's career by another house.
Alan, mental health therapist, go ahead.
Yeah, Casey, are you there?
Yeah.
Do you have these thoughts, these intrusive thoughts quite a bit? And they tend to scare you, and you don't know where they're coming from.
Yeah. You know what it sounds like to me?
See, he doesn't even know it's his head talking to him.
Obsessive compulsive disorder.
That's right.
No, it's not.
What do I do?
It's an offshoot
of
that.
What do I do that's compulsive? I'm superstitious a little bit.
Well, wait, stop. You just said he's superstitious.
Well, like what? Give me some of the superstitions.
Well, before I used to have a match, I would do the same stretching. I would say the same thing to the opponent.
Yes, it is. That's compulsive.
Before a game, I would go through the same. Plays and stuff like that.
It's not how sports is very
hallucination.
No,
sports is very
that's
the difference is he did it because he liked doing it as opposed to
you did. Jackie just snuck up on KC and hey, Alan, thanks.
You did it because you thought you were going to die.
Let Alan talk. He's a professional.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay. Well, KC, you realize the thoughts are crazy.
Right.
You have them anyway, and you have anxiety as a result of them.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much OCD, and then some folks have the compulsions that go along with that. They try to undo it, right? You have it counts, or you think about something, or whatever. So there is medication that would fix that for you.
But wait a minute, they
want to destroy you. They want to kill you.
They want
to. Robin was.
Right. The guys are trying to help, man.
The fact that he thinks that he's being poisoned.
Well, it's okay, but see, the difference between that and psychotic stuff is he recognizes the thought is crazy.
Right. That's OCD.
Some of the obsessions can be about, like, there's one about a father who was had obsessions about killing his baby with a hammer, but he didn't intend to do it.
Yes, I get those too, but right. I know I would never do it.
Right, that's the difference.
Right.
Oh, man.
You know you wouldn't do it. So the point is you have OCD.
I get these weird thoughts like that, like the killing of a baby or something like that, but I know I would never do that.
Right.
That's right. That's,
everybody gets
that's
those
what
type
OCD
of thoughts.
No, they don't.
You give it some
No, they don't.
You may not recognize the thought, but it's there.
Do you ever lay in bed dreaming of choking your girlfriend to death?
Not my girlfriend.
She wouldn't do anything to you.
You need to see a doctor about getting on something like Paxil or an Afrinil.
No way.
Lumox.
I'll kill you.
And it'll work.
Nope.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something. You got big problems, son.
Hey, tell me something I don't know, pal.
All right. But thank you, Alan.
He's going to talk to somebody, but he won't do it, Aaron.
No.
I would do it.
Yeah, all right. You better go do it.
Like I said,
he just wet the bed.
I know. I think that's
the
turning point.
Yeah.
I think there's something that needs to be done.
All right.
Oh,
all
good for you.
Yeah.
He's finally admitting that he's
going to... I'm
working on getting it up, too.
I'm waiting for Casey to start running down the hall yelling, I'm on fire.
See, Howard, now you see why he can't get up.
What are you talking about?
He's having these problems before, you know what I mean?
I'm just worried that it's going to get worse, and I don't want to lose you. I like you. You're nice.
Okay, let me ask you one question. Before you have sex, do you have any of these...
No, I have no problem performing.
Is there any, like, kind of ritual that you got to do?
You should take tips from me, my friend.
No, I'm asking. Do you have any...
I'm nice.
Is there a ritual, like anything you do in your head before you have sex? Be honest.
No!
No!
I need to.
He's no!
All right, we got to take a break. This is fascinating.
Crazy. Room oh yeah, you guys.
No, Julie, you're really crazy. All right, we're gonna take
a
break.
I'm really worrying about him.
Yeah, you should.
That
you
is
should.
Spring wound.
You should.
Tight.
And he's like 20. What? 3?
How old are you, dude?
25.
Oh, yeah. All right,
kill somebody by 28.
No, I thought I was gonna years ago, but not anymore. I don't feel that way anymore.
Look on the bright side. You left about a third over.
I know. Jesus Christ.
You only got 50 more years.
I know. Keep
all right.
That crap?
We'll be back right after this. Casey told me something during the commercials that is so disturbing, I just don't know that I can even figure out how to tell you.
He must want you.
He comes in and he says to me,
he must want you to.
I could say it this way. Okay. I'm just trying to clean it up for the radio. Cause
what happened now?
He says,
Oh, boy.
He says, over vacation, I accidentally...
What?
Let out more than he bargained for?
He went to the... See, I don't know what we can say or what we can't say. I'm so confused.
Did he have an accident?
He had an accident on his girlfriend.
Whoops.
What?
That's good. He had an accident on his girlfriend.
Wow.
Here's what happened. But not even the accident you're thinking.
But his accident was bad enough to be...
Yeah, he goes...
It was worse?
He goes, I was in bed with my girlfriend... And she was doing something. He goes, to punish her, I was going to fart on her. And what were you drinking? A lot of apple juice?
Yeah, well, she drank all the orange juice. So there was only apple juice in the refrigerator.
So he went to fart, and he ended up giving her a tan.
Oh!
What to look for?
What,
you never did that?
Oh, you're a disgusting pig.
Mr. X, never did that to you? As a joke?
Oh,
what, fart on her?
Yeah, as a joke?
Yeah, I mean, he never missed.
No. Your boyfriend farted on you?
No, I mean, not even in bed or anything.
Right.
Where were you?
I was in bed.
But, he held her down. Like, where were you farting? On her face?
No. That would be wrong.
Where?
I just kind of on her arm or something like that.
And he had...
Poor girl.
And he lost control of his bodily function.
This pussy, how long... What do you have to do to make her laugh?
I know, that's what I asked.
That's what you're trying to do.
Yeah, what are you doing with me?
That's what I said. I said, what
she's
are you
a
doing?
Beautiful girl, too.
Well, thank you.
She is.
Yeah, but it was the weirdest thing. Like, you know, apple juice, I guess, I can't digest. You know what I mean?
Right.
And we're not talking about a couple teaspoons of mistake.
Right.
We're talking about a lot.
Right.
I'm talking down the...
And you...
As I got up from the bed... It kind of trailed with me, so I left a mark on the floor.
You know, you can say that.
So I had to get down on hands and knees when I was done with paper towels and like Windex spraying it.
Windex.
And where is she?
Windex.
Is she running
around? What are you doing on a window?
She was sick. She wasn't feeling well.
Guys never know how to clean up. Windex.
Windex on the floor.
Smushes it
That's
around.
That's a glass, Casey.
Yeah.
You know, the funny thing, Howard, is when his, you know, his girlfriend used to work here, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, she just was so classy that she seemed as if she wouldn't date anybody who didn't have any class. You know, right. He wasn't the right kind of guy. Yet she stayed through 3-4 of these episodes. And I was
No, that was when he wet the bed. I'm not talking about wetting the bed.
But I know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about he had a real accident.
But I'm saying that he keeps doing these things. And I was talking to somebody who was an outsider, and we were playing that game. I was playing that game with the interns. You know, who would you rather be with, this one or that one? And I said KC or somebody, and they go, KC, he's gross. He does that thing, and he can't control himself. And why is that girl still with him?
Yeah, I know. I ask the same thing sometimes.
Right. Why would you try to pass wind on her arm?
Because Casey's good looking.
But you never did that.
She's into him because he looks the right part.
She can't believe he's such a mess, I guess.
Right. You don't think I'm a nice
looking
guy?
Looking at him.
No, you're a nice guy. But with chicks, I mean, if you go to fart on a chick and you lose control.
Nobody.
No girl's going to hang around for that.
That's a first, Casey. That is a first.
It was a joke.
No, I understand. On some level,
like on the first date, you would never do that.
Right. Right. I didn't pass wind in front of him for the first
right.
couple
but
months.
You did more than pass wind. You lost control.
Yeah, I did.
And you were like,
have you seen a urologist?
Oh,
urologist.
You know what? We're talking about a proctologist, bro. What do you think of?
Yeah. You don't understand
what happened.
I don't know. No. Yeah.
No, he went to fart and had an accident.
Oh, yeah. I guess I'm so caught up in the other bedwetting thing that I didn't get to the bed.
Yeah, no, he had to go to a proctologist.
Oh, man.
Yeah,
so you know what? So I went to...
Oh.
Yeah, you like that, huh?
But wait a second. And then he tried to clean it with Windex.
Yeah, I was down on my hands and knees.
Now, Windex.
Why were you naked?
Windex people didn't invent that. Windex people didn't invent that.
When he heard that cleans deep in the corners.
He had his shorts on, but that didn't stop. That didn't stop the accident.
I had sweatpants on, so I was thinking, do I keep the sweatpants or do I wash them?
All right.
Oh, man.
Oh. Throw them away.
So, no, I put them in a bag and I tied it up, so it looked like a diaper. And then I went down to wash, and I just left it down there.
You left it in the laundry room?
Can you imagine living anywhere
in your building?
Yeah.
You left your dirty sweatpants?
I washed it, though. I put it in the washer.
Wait. When you put the washer, when you pulled the wet sweatpants out, are they still staying in there?
Someone had pulled them out and left them to the side.
Oh.
And also, there was a towel and a T-shirt in there, too.
So, wait a second. Where are the sweatpants now?
I don't know.
Oh, you left them down there wet?
Yeah.
Did it wash everything out?
I didn't check.
Let me ask you a question. Just a little common sense. Actually, you know what I did?
Why'd you bother washing them and then throw them out?
No, because I was going to... It was my favorite pair of sweatpants. I really like
them. A little common sense. Because I know it's like...
It's lucky pants.
Why would you take something that has basically been ruined and wash it with clean stuff? You put in a towel and a T-shirt.
No. The T-shirt and the towel was dirty, too.
Yeah, they were all dirty.
I had to get in the shower. This is the most disgusting thing.
Oh.
On my leg hair, there was thick stuff caught in my leg hair.
Oh, wow.
And the old great Howard...
What?
Is that, you know, his girlfriend, when she was here, you know, she's pretty hot and everything.
Right.
I always felt she thought that we were all disgusting and stuff.
Yeah, Casey's disgusting.
She thinks that he was like this clean cut, you know, guy.
No, she thinks I'm disgusting. Don't you worry.
Okay, so while you're showering and putting things in a bag and everything, she's doing what?
Yeah, she had to clean herself.
I told her, I said, look, hon, just do me a favor. Stay in bed, will you?
Yeah, she was sick. She had to stay in bed the whole
time. Yeah, she was
sick. Doing all this.
Yeah.
She stayed in bed while he used Windex.
And you know something else I found out?
You know Windex is not used for that.
Hey, Howard, you know what I found out? You know you don't digest the mushrooms either.
Well, good for sharing.
It's like corn.
Wait a minute. Didn't he say he got her dirty?
A little bit, yeah. Hey, you know what? You know what? By the way, I read an article in Maxim. Why is it that corn...
I read that too.
That is never digested.
What did they say? I forgot.
Me too.
I just forgot
to give the answer. I got to remember.
I read it. And I thought it wasn't that interesting.
Yeah, it was like the body doesn't break. Oh, it adds
fiber
for bulk to our movements.
Right.
And I forgot. I'm not gonna lie and tell you I remember. Yeah. I was hoping somebody might have read it.
I did read it, but I forgot. But mushrooms. Some of them were like half. Oh, you know.
Did you chew your food?
No. I guess not.
what is
blowing my mind?
Why is apple juice blowing you away?
I don't know.
Does anyone else have that problem?
No. Nobody has your problems. Trust me.
Wow. Dude, I mean, I don't understand something. So, like, let's say you had a little. It was a full blown out accident.
Oh my god, dude! I mean, as soon as it went out, I was like, oh my god. Wait, just stay there. Don't move.
You make it in your pants.
Oh,
have you visited your shrink since this episode?
No, I have to go tonight. I actually stopped going for a while.
Are you going to tell him?
I'm going to fart on him.
It's because I was drinking apple juice. It doesn't have a white mental.
But why are you farting on your girlfriend, man?
Because it was a joke. She was like,
that's a funny joke.
She was, I don't know. She was hitting that.
Don't think that's funny.
But I do.
It's humorous for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I crack myself up. I'll be by myself and I'll just rip one. It's funny.
Yeah.
I laugh.
I rip one too, but I'm never making my pants. Like, even sometimes, like, maybe a little something I feel is happening down there, I quickly control it.
So, but I didn't know. I thought
you completely lost control.
Oh, my God. It was a rocket.
Well, see, that has happened. That has happened to me, Howard. That happened to me about a year ago, remember?
You made in your pants.
I was buying my house, and I was all freaking out about mortgages and selling and buying, and I was in the bathroom. My stomach was churning, and then I had an accident. You know, I thought I was doing one thing, and the other thing happened.
Hey, wait, now, what did you do with your underwear?
That's exactly what I did with it. I always have my gym bag with me?
Uh-huh.
Luckily, there's another pair of underwear in the gym bag. And that's what I did. I went in the stall. I hope nobody came in and saw what I was doing, because I had to take my sneakers off and everything. And I took the underwear, and I wrapped it in a bunch of paper towels, and I jammed it deep into that garbage pail.
Oh,
wow.
I wish we would have found it.
Yeah, we should have found it. Hung it right on the wall.
That's like that movie with Michael Landon.
Yeah. No. Oh, man.
I'm so embarrassed.
All right, and she made me make one of those, like, New Year's revolutions.
I used to have accidents when I was little. What is that?
She made me make, like, one of those New Year's revolutions, like...
Come on!
I mean, to, you know, like, I can't really do that much anymore.
The New Year's what?
The New Year's revolution.
He's gotta be kidding, right?
He's not.
Look at Sean.
Oh, this is my fault. Oh, you
know what I'm talking about.
There's no life. Right, you know what I mean.
It would be.
So you made a New Year's revolution. And
number nine.
You know, that I'm not gonna you know, goof around that much anymore.
You know how he knows that kidding about that, Howard?
Because
he
doesn't even know what to.
He's getting the angry look.
Yeah, yeah.
Because he knows he did something wrong. He doesn't know what it is.
No, come on.
So what do you do? So what do you do? What do you do every year? You make a what?
No, I know. I screwed up.
What is it?
Prostitution.
It's a New Year's resolution.
Resolution. There you go.
Come on, give a break and hit him after six or seven times.
Yeah, but you know. Right. Wow, you're dumber than I thought.
Yeah, but you know, but apple juice doesn't make you do that.
Change the subject.
His girlfriend likes a big, good-looking, dumb, and in convict.
Yeah.
What? Apple juice is supposed to make you constipated, no?
No. Any juice or any vegetables or fruits.
Screws up your vocabulary.
No, but the apple juice is the only one that
makes you forget how to talk.
Apple juice.
Apple juice, man.
Yeah, well, maybe you ought to lay off it.
How much did you drink?
I used to have accidents sometimes, like in my underpants when I was, like, in kindergarten. Like, in kindergarten, I remember I didn't want to use the bathroom at the kindergarten. And I knew I had to, you know, move my bowels.
Uh-huh.
And then, like, I remember...
So you'd rather go on you.
Well, I remember, like, I kind of went in my pants, halfway, and I went in the bathroom, and I looked in my underwear, and everything was in there. And I just sat in it all day. And it's like,
I couldn't... wonder why you weren't popular.
I couldn't take it, yeah. I couldn't take, like, my underwear off and ditch it, because my mom used to sew my name into my underpants. So, you know, Howard Stern.
These are the underwear up.
Yeah. But it's just like it became mortar after a while, like in my underwear. So it was like a big mortar pile. But then, like, even sometimes I got a little older. I'm a little
older. Little older. What's a little older?
17, 18.
Oh,
yeah, racing stripe here.
Oh, my.
Yeah, I got racing stripes.
Not a trail in the room.
Now I'm pretty good, though. I don't have that many, actually.
I get the itchy underwear a lot.
Yeah, well, you have a whole issue.
Can I just remind you of the greatest story of all time? Our very own Ronnie, the limo driver, had a similar accident while he was driving, and he didn't know what to do.
So he tossed his underwear out the window.
He went into Central Park and threw it in a tree.
Yeah. I remember that. That's nothing. He's got a friend. I know I've told this story on the air, but it's worth telling again. He's got a friend who's a limo driver, the guy, you know, and limo drivers have, God bless them, they have a hard time. Cab drivers, they have to go to the bathroom. You're here in New York, you see cab drivers open the door and just, you know, whiz out the door. So he had a friend, he was, had to pick up this rabbi out on Long Island. And he's waiting and waiting in front of the rabbi's house, and all of a sudden he realizes he's got to go number two. So the guy, he goes and he rings the rabbi's doorbell, and he says, "Hey, rabbi, can I use your, bathroom?" And the rabbi's like, no bathroom, please, you know. You got to see this driver, though, you know. That's not some guy letting your house. So, rabbi goes, "No, whatever. I think a religious guy would let you."
Yeah, really? Right.
You know the Jews.
For religion.
So anyway, he goes back in the car. He's like, "I don't know what I'm going to do. So in real emergencies, in his trunk, he keeps a cardboard box. So he gets the cardboard box, he goes into the back of the limo, and he's
in front of somebody's house.
Yeah, and he gets in there and he goes in the cardboard box. Listen to this. Now, you know when you go to the bathroom.
Wait a minute, does he have, you know, the rest of the stuff he needs?
I don't know. Forget, he just had to go. It didn't matter.
The whole kit, you mean?
Yeah, like papers and stuff. Whatever. So, you know when you go to the bathroom, just a regular bathroom, the whole bathroom stinks. All of a sudden, he's in the middle of going in the box. The rabbi's knocking on the glass.
He wants to get in the car.
He grabs his box, pulls his pants up, gets out, goes, "Oh, rabbi, let me open the door for you." Opens the door to the rabbi. The guy is dying to stink. So meanwhile, he had it like he didn't even get the box back in the trunk. He closed the trunk, brings the box up front with him. Now he threw the box out the window. Isn't that a great story?
That's awesome.
The rabbi's back there in the stink.
Hey, was he done right? Though?
Yeah. Yeah, he was kind of done, but it was rushed.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Where's the worst place that you ever went?
My girlfriend.
Hey, honey, I love you.
Maybe in a limo. Not a number two, though. Number one.
I had a friend who climbed a tree one time, took a number two.
A latrine?
No, a tree.
I did that.
Oh,
I've done that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, when I was at summer camp. They called it a latrine, but but it was a tree.
I mean, you didn't climb the tree.
Well, you had to climb up on a log, yeah.
Oh, really?
And you just hang your butt off, and you dig a hole, and bombs are
up. Oh, wait a minute. You're like, the log,
Yeah.
But this KC's talking about climbing up in the tree and actually, like,
yeah, he's talking about a different kind of thing.
Oh, like a monkey.
Yeah.
Like you did off a bridge, right?
Yeah.
No out of window.
Out of window.
Most normal. Bridge.
Off a bridge. Why'd you do it off a bridge? Just to see it fall?
Be an idiot.
Seventh grade. Well, you reached your goal.
Seventh grade. You know it was probably senior year.
Yeah.
College.
Because KC is another loser. He comes to me and he goes,
capital L.
Well, I see his knuckles are all, like he punched somebody. I see his knuckles are all bruised. I said, "What'd you hit?" I smashed my answering machine with my fists.
Really?
Yeah. I'm worried about him. He was mad.
Don't be worried about me, bro.
On his hand.
Yeah. Well, of course. What do you think that is? He hit something. So I said, why would you smash your answering machine? You're a guy. You don't have a pot to pee in.
An answering machine. What did the answering machine do to you?
Well,
he had a reason.
No, he had a reason.
What was that?
The reason was he bet on a horse at the track and it lost.
That our horse?
Yeah. And he was so mad that he punched his answering machine.
I told you about that horse. That horse couldn't lose, Howard.
Yeah. It couldn't. See, Howard, this horse. Last two times I watched, I was waiting for this thing for a month, right?
Right.
Last two times, I had so much horse right at the end, got caught at the rail, and couldn't get out. So I'm like, next time it goes, I'm going to go yard on it. I'm gonna go and try really hard, right?
Right.
The horse, it comes out and takes an S. You know what I mean? It did nothing.
It did, okay.
It was the last horse in the race.
It wasn't last. It was fifth. The whole time, the announcer's like, no excuses this time for Mandar. You know what I mean? No excuses.
Mm. All right.
And there was plenty of excuses.
His real problem is he is sure he doesn't have a problem.
That's no, I don't have a problem. I got a hobby.
a hobby that takes
it's something. It's something that I enjoy. I do it on the weekends.
It sounds enjoyable. You're smashing ants.
Look, I smash things anyway.
Well, he has no money. He can't pay his rent. I said, you know what? You got a problem. I said, you want me to sit you down and give you a talking to after the show in a serious way? I'll do it.
I need a talking to.
You need talking to a gambler.
Because nobody's ever talked to this guy.
He's got an illness.
Well, I got plenty of problems, and gambling is not at the top of the list.
I said to him, listen. I said, that's not a hobby. Soon your hobby's going to be living in a cardboard box.
Good.
I said, good. So it is a hobby.
I don't care.
I said, look, you got a problem. I'm going to give you a talking to after the show. So then he got nervous. I saw his eyes watering up. He got nervous about the talking to.
Watered up?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Stop it. Stop it.
So I said, look. I'm going to give you a talking to, and we're going to put you in this Gamblers Anonymous.
Oh, you're going to put him in?
Why want to go there? A bunch of losers.
Guess where you belong.
I don't care. I got a hobby. What do you enjoy? What do you enjoy doing?
So I said, enjoy beating your ass.
I said, if you want a hobby, your hobby could be every time you feel like gambling, write a funny bit for the show, which I haven't seen in a while.
Gamble on that.
Yeah.
Gamble on being funny.
But he goes, what else should I do? I go, that's what you do.
Right.
Do some work.
What do you mean do? So I do plenty of work.
You don't need time for a hobby. That's not a hobby. Looking at horses run.
No way. It's good, man. It's just so much to it.
All right. All right. Now you can leave.
Please.
Now go.
Do you think you can talk to that?
Yeah. Not on the air. Off the air.
I appreciate your concern.
I'm
going to
give you
a talk.
You'll get the talk after the show.
No, I don't.
We got a problem.
It's
nothing. You want to know the truth? There's nothing funny about what you're saying.
Talk to that shirt. I've talked to him. I've tried to say, what do you like about losing? Because he was like, no, I like the winning. I said, but you don't win.
Yeah. He goes, there's always a chance I could turn my life around if I win.
All right.
Look, I'm looking for that last final payoff, and I'm gone. That's all.
Pie in the sky.
What would the payoff be, $100?
No, dude. You hit like a superfecta or something like that.
What? How much?
$20,000.
$20,000. Oh, that's what you're waiting. You're never going to hit that.
I know.
Have you ever gotten close? No.
Never.
You could retire on that.
But you know what? You know, you can win like, you know, $1,100. That's not out of the question.
Right. But
have you done that?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. You can go now. That's silly. You're being silly.
Why is that silly?
You guys got a lot of problems.
He's never won anything because he's lost so much.
You're going to do something new.
Your father did a number on you, and you really ought to, instead of, you know what your hobby should be? Get some money together and go see a therapist.
What are you talking? I go to a therapist.
Yeah, one day a week ain't going to make a dent in that parade that's in your head. His father did a number on him.
What are you talking about? My father didn't do a number on me.
Why didn't your father let you play basketball? Why don't you tell everybody?
That's a joke, man. You guys,
a joke?
You,
why didn't you play basketball?
Okay, my father was a wrestling coach, and he said if I played basketball, I would get warts on my hands.
Right. Why did he say that?
So I wouldn't play basketball.
Why did
You're
he want
kidding.
You to?
He gave him that fairy tale?
Yeah.
It's a joke. But the thing is, I believed it until I was like 13.
All right.
Oh, my goodness.
That's why you're pooping in bed.
No, I don't. You
make it in a bed like a baby. Get out of here now. I got to do funny bits. No one wants to hear your life story. I want to tell you how crazy KC, who works for us, is.
Oh, how crazy is
he? Comes in this morning. He's not feeling well. I said, why aren't you feeling well? He said, come in and tell the story, you wacko. This guy's nuts. You talk about anger.
Yeah.
You know, I thought Ronnie the limo driver was the angriest driver on the planet. Man, you've got anger management issues all over the place.
And
tell,
we had to already go to class. It didn't help.
Tell everybody your story.
It had nothing to do with anger.
Oh, boy.
I think you're angry because maybe you are gay.
Wow.
Why does it always have to come back to being gay? Why can't it just be something else?
It's not with you.
All right, fine. I'm gay.
Because you couldn't get it up.
Again?
Whatever.
Well, in many cases, I don't know about now.
That's what you think.
You having any problems recently?
No.
He's got a new girlfriend. If you can't get it up for her, he's got a hot girlfriend that he met through the show.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it.
You had any problems with her?
I have no problems.
Well, she's patient.
Yeah.
You know what?
Just give me some time.
You could be in the wrong area here. Don't worry about Fred. Worry about this one.
Yeah, I'm not worried about Fred.
Honey, go for a walk.
Come back. I got to relax.
Nice.
Maybe if I touch myself, I'll get around.
I'm open pictures of football players.
So really, tell Robin what happened. Why are you injured today?
Well, I'm not injured. I just told Howard, you know, he was wrapping me with this morning. He's like, you know, what's going on? I'm like, you know, to be honest with you, I'm dragging my ass today. I'm a little tired. He's like, why? I said, well, I had to drive back to Long Island after I got out of here last night.
Yeah.
I left about 6:30, so I have to drive back because my car's there because I broke my windshield.
How tell her how you broke
your
it.
Windshield?
See, I was moving some stuff. I had it in my car, and I keep a bat in my car, right? So
why do you keep a bat in your car?
Well, I'm paranoid. I take it. I sleep with next to me.
Okay.
What?
All right.
Where does he live?
I don't know. Who does he think?
It's going to be a game, you know.
Yeah, be a game.
Game would break out the middle of the night.
No, I know a lot of guys who carry bats in case they get in a traffic accident. They have to kick the crap out of somebody. They beat them with a bat.
But mainly,
because you can't carry a gun.
How about not getting into an argument?
Come on. I was moving, so I take this and I keep it.
Your baseball bat, right?
So I have it in the back. There's a bunch of stuff that's on top of it. So I'm pulling on it, and I have no patience, right? So I'm pulling on this thing, and it's stuck between two boxes. So I really, really wail on it. And it comes free and smashes my windshield.
No, you know what it is? You got frustrated that you couldn't get the bat out of the back seat, and you took it and slammed it into the windshield.
No.
Yes.
I know exactly what he did. He has a very short leash.
Right.
And when he gets tired and stressed, things better work right.
And what is it?
And if they don't work right, he'll ruin everything.
Right, and he works a full-time job. Then he goes to that dopey gym. And he works himself into a sweat.
Right, he's exhausted.
He's exhausted, and then he.
And so everything irritates him.
Right.
Yeah. I was kind of angry.
So you smashed in your own windshield.
Yes. Howard, you know what you're missing?
What?
Do you know how hard you have to hit a windshield?
Yes, you really have to.
Oh, yeah. No, I didn't hit it hard at all.
Yeah.
Oh, please. You've got the only fragile windshield.
I don't know my own strength.
Whoop.
I'm Hercules.
I couldn't believe it. It's a pain in the ass. But, you know, I got my insurance picked it up. So that's good.
Big shout out. Lords of London.
Lords of London. All right, thank you, Casey.
Okay.
What is it, stuttering John?
Casey's got a lot of weird stories going on.
Right.
And one was he needed money to pay his rent.
Right.
And so he had to drive all the way back to Long Island to get the money out of his bank. So
that's just because I don't have a bank here in the city.
But then Gary offers to lend him money.
Right.
He won't accept it.
Here's the deal. No, I don't accept money from my friends.
But you're going to write him a check the next day.
I don't care.
Well, he doesn't have like an ATM card?
No. He's got to go to this one bank
an
exit 68 on the LIE.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like beyond near the lighthouse.
Dude, what's your problem?
Somebody get him a bank in Manhattan.
No, I mean, I have to open up an account here in Manhattan.
So do it. It takes 5 minutes.
Yeah, but I don't know. I know I have to. I should do that. You're right.
Hey, Fred, your status is being threatened.
Really?
As the latest guy on the show.
I'm
you know, I always
you.
The mantle always has to go on to somebody younger. I like my bank, okay? They're nice to me there.
But why go all the way out to exit 68 to go to a bank?
They weren't nice enough to give you the money without you driving to Timbuktu.
No, because they just felt
Timbuktu.
62. I'm sorry.
68, that's Martha's Vineyard.
He's got to get on a ferry to get his bank.
Dude, you go to any bank, they're just as nice.
Not at all.
No, the ATM is lovely.
Nice.
Yeah, I got an ATM, but I have to go back there and, you know, take care of it.
You can take money out of a particular ATM account.
Because I have to go back there and put it in so I can take it out.
Huh?
No, you don't.
But you
what
don't.
Is wrong with him?
Yeah, I do. Trust me, I do.
He's always juggling money, which I understand. Right. But, like, I think I have a pretty good relationship with Casey, and
right.
I certainly trust him.
Right.
He's a very trustworthy guy.
You know where he's
going to
be.
And I said, listen, on Monday...
You'll pay me back.
Here. I trust you. He goes, I just don't like owing people money. And I go, but it's me.
I know. He's real weird because I give him, he'll say to me, he'll go out and buy my food. And it's $90 for the week, so I'll give him $100. And I go, just take the 10. You can use it for yourself. He goes, no, I don't want to do that. I go, take the 10 and apply it to next week. Don't give me any
chance. No, I don't want to do that.
No, I don't want to. You can't keep track of it.
It just has to do with where you stand with people. You know what I mean?
No, it doesn't. You have OCD.
But don't you think it means I think a lot of you that I would
need
some money?
That's great. And you're a good friend, man. But, you know.
He's got some kind of fetish.
I know when I asked him to go to that dinner, he almost lost his mind. It was really bothering him. You know, you try to do something nice for a person.
Yeah.
And then he was worried the entire 2 weeks it took to get to the dinner.
All right. Enough of him.
What do I wear? What do I do?
Call this segment Crazy People Who Work on the Show.
What do I do?
He said, what do I do?
There's so many gay KC calls.
Wow.
Really, unbelievable. I mean, they don't stop.
Hi, Casey. This is Les Simpson, and I'm the editor of the gay and lesbian section of Time Out magazine. And I was wondering if you might be interested in being profiled for our upcoming sex issue. We do a sex issue each year, and I certainly thought you'd be appropriate since you have become kind of a gay icon and a sex symbol for the gay community. I listen to the show every morning, and I certainly know that Howard and the gang teases you a lot about being gay, and I thought that we could do a Q&A about why they tease you and what your feelings are and why they even think that you might be gay.
Yeah.
Also, I know that you were in the Chicago Gay Day Parade, and I could get your feelings about that. And if what the sensation was like, if you enjoyed it, if you enjoy, I guess, being the object of affection for gay people across America in general.
Right. Is he going to do that?
No. You know he's not. He's too uptight.
Come on.
And you know what that's like? That's like if I wanted to interview a hot chick, you know what I mean? Because I wanted to meet her. What's up?
I sort of feel bad for Casey because, you know, when we come back from the weekend and stuff, we'll ask each other, you know, what'd you do this weekend? And if Casey has an appearance, I'll ask him how it went. And he goes, oh, man. He goes, it's just the worst. And I go, why? What's so bad? And he goes, you know, you're at this club and you get up on stage and the second you hit the stage, it's faggot, homo, faggot.
Yeah, I don't know how he got into that. He's a manly dude.
I feel bad for him. Mm.
Although he has a lifting group. Did you hear about this? On Sundays, he goes to the gym and has a lifting group.
There's a whole group. They get together just to lift.
Yeah, they lift their weights.
Where's my lifting group?
I never heard it called a lifting group.
I never heard of that in my life.
Yeah. You're muscular.
You've got a great ass.
Yeah. Hey, your ass is pretty great, too.
Come on, let me see it.
It'll never fit.
Oh, so don't you think five guys fit? What do they do in a lifting group?
Well, I guess it's a bunch of guys who like to weight lift.
Not me.
But doesn't that sound odd, like five guys getting together? It's, you know, just you gotta know they're all complimenting each other and saying, hey, way to go.
Or, yeah, you look great.
I've heard of somebody, you know, having a partner so you could spot each other, but a lifting group?
A group.
You got a lifting group.
Well, I got a trainer and sometimes some guys join us, but I don't know if we have a lifting group.
Yeah. You don't meet regularly.
Yeah, I when I was in college, we had groups. We had, 6 o'clock group. We had the 1 o'clock group, 2 o'clock group. We had like five groups.
And did you go to all the groups?
No. I went to one each day. I did a 6 o'clock a couple times, and then when I do the heavy lifting, I would go at night because I can't lift heavy in the morning.
You can't? Why?
Yeah, my body just doesn't function. It doesn't hit it right.
My butt's sore.
When you guys are lifting, what is it, like five or six guys? In a group, there's four guys.
We encourage each other.
And what do you talk about?
We pair off. First you talk about the weights, and then, like, shaving.
Well, is it like
hey,
one of
what kind of gloves you got?
Weightlifting shows where they go, oh, yeah, you know, now you're making a muscle, and they touch your muscle, and...
Posing.
Yeah, you know what?
Hey, I really feel my tries. You're huge, man.
When you kind of think about it, it is...
Oil my sphincter.
You got one more in you.
You guys have to, like, after you guys finish doing... Like, if a guy does, you know, some amazing amount, and he bench presses it, and he finishes it, do you guys all compliment him? Hey, smack him on the ass, whatever.
Yeah.
Hey, you look great. Oh, muscular.
Are you going heavier?
Yeah. Hey, someone just told me my ass didn't look that great. Hey, let's see your ass.
Right. Do you show each other?
Yeah, what? You're doing squats? Oh. Hey, you know, you check it out. Casey, when somebody finishes lifting, right, and, you know, guys been working out, after you're done lifting, you go to the mirror and you look, right? Oh, yeah. Or the guy shows it to the other guy.
Yeah, hell yeah. Look at this. Look at this.
Some guys who do it right in the gym there. They lift up straight. You know, am I getting abs? Am I getting them?
Do you ever do pose down?
No, I never.
You know a guy who lifts his shirt and says, am I getting abs? You know he has abs. He just wants everyone
to look. Some of the fat linemen would do it, too. Like, hey, am I getting anything? Am I getting anything?
No.
But what do you wear in your group?
Tights. You know, we'd have to wear, like, some guys would wear, like, a half shirt. Some guys would wear that.
Is that really true?
No, because we had, some of the shirts, like a lot of the running backs would wear the cut-off shirts, so your gut would hang out and the ball could stick to your skin.
But why do you have to, when you lift weights, do you have to wear your running back shirt?
That's the undershirt that we had. You know, some guys would have that.
Half shirt?
And some of the linemen would like to just show their gut. They just like that.
And what'd you wear on the bottom?
Daisy Dukes.
Kind of like the girdle, you know, the tight...
tight spandex?
With shorts over it.
With shorts over it, yeah. So you tie up your blouse?
Oh! What? Doing aerobics.
And I wear a fruit hat.
Hey, we did that. We did an aerobics class one time.
Really?
You want to feel like a fairy? Go do that. I couldn't even do it right.
Let me tell you, it's hard.
It is
hard. Aerobics is tough. That separates the men from the women.
Step, step. I couldn't even do it.
When you do aerobics, do you wear like a sundress or do you wear the same thing? You cut off blouse.
The same thing.
Well, it's color coordinated.
I like my abs to show.
And did you get the little step and try to step over?
I couldn't do it. There was women ahead of me, and I'm getting
a belly ring.
I couldn't do it. The women could do it. I couldn't do it. I felt like a big turd, you know.
Right.
I'm thinking of getting a little heart tattoo on my ankle. What do you think? Sexy. Muscular.
Well, you have a lift. You have like four guys you lift with, right?
No. I mean, you go to the gym and you lift. Whoever's there, you lift.
Well, I mean, you know, whatever.
All right, anyway. Guess who has no voice today? You got to hear this. This is good for a quick laugh. Ganji, come in and say if the rain in Spain falls mainly on the plane. You got to hear this guy.
No.
He's got no voice.
Where does it go?
Isn't it weird how God makes a voice for some people that can barely be understood? It's like, I asked him once, does it hurt when you talk? He goes, yeah.
But I think it must be the mechanics.
He's almost a dog.
What are you talking about?
Let me hear you say the rain in Spain falls mainly on the plane.
The rain in Spain falls mainly on the plane.
Does it hurt when you talk?
Yes, today it does.
God.
Today it hurts a lot, actually.
You wake up and you never can talk. Why can't you talk? What'd you do last night?
I went out and watched the Yankee game, and what happened was I was at a bar, and I was with a bunch of friends, so I was trying to talk to everybody.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a loud environment.
Yelling over.
Yelling everybody.
Oh,
yeah. Yelling over everybody.
Man, you'd lose your voice so quickly.
In a heartbeat. Yeah. I knew last night, like, at one point I was just like, oh my God, my voice is gone. It just was like, it went from being normal to being gone in like 2 seconds.
And when you go to sleep, it doesn't get refreshed?
Nothing.
No.
No. It takes
Were you drinking?
Days. Yeah, I had a couple drinks, but I don't think drinking has anything to do with it. It's the level. It's the level I was speaking at.
Right.
It went from normal.
But your voice should be able to recover.
You know what?
It never has been.
You should have handicap plates.
I wish I could.
What?
Dehydration.
Yes.
Drink a lot of water.
I think so.
You would be in better shape.
Not that your voice was ever normal. But
right, I mean, I never had a normal voice, and it was always like this. So, I mean, have I always been dehydrated?
Do your brothers sound like this?
No, the only one.
It's always like this.
I'm the only one that sounds like this.
Don't think it's sexy.
It's kind of got that sexy raspy thing.
And the guys in my lifting group think it's sexy. You sound like Joan Rivers.
You got a great ass.
I wonder, like,
because I go out there and I go, "What's wrong with you? My voice is dying."
I wonder, like, if people listen to you on the air, do you sound like an old man, or like, what do you sound like? If I didn't know what you look like.
Hey, how you doing? I mean, I would think I sound like a young guy still. I don't think it sounds like an old voice. It just sounds. It sounds not strong.
I just wonder what it sounds like to other people. Hey, you know who's here? Is Dougie, Doug Goodstein, who came back from his honeymoon.
Honeymoon boy.
Yeah, honeymoon boy is here.
Maybe he ought to read his vows with you.
I was over at Lotus Saturday night.
Yeah.
And this chick was totally checking out Doug.
He was there?
Yeah, he was there. He was there with his wife, his new wife. Him and Marlo.
The girl checking him out?
Yeah, Mr. and Mrs. Goodstein like to make appearances together now.
Ooh. Yeah, 6 months ago he went by with guys, you know, like to go hang out. Now he's bringing his
Well, now he's married.
I still do the guy thing. Shut up, you fatso.
Fatso with no voice. So anyway, we're there, and this cute chick who I know was totally checking out Doug.
Who's that, huh?
Did you hear this from her?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
And she dug you, and you were all over her, man. You were like, I don't mean you were touching her or anything, but you were talking, your wife's standing right next to you, you were like engrossed in conversation with her.
Marlo knows her, too. We were both talking to her.
Well,
I wasn't flirting with her. What do you think, I'm crazy?
Looked that way to me, like there was a little bit of chemistry.
She's a nice girl.
Yeah, tell me you didn't want her.
I didn't want her.
Okay.
It's not my type. No, she's not,
you leave your penis
she's not a Jew.
Why is that important?
No, I'm just kidding. No. It's not important.
It is, too.
So it totally is.
Well, that's
I've dated non-Jews. I just, you know.
You wouldn't marry a non-Jew.
No.
Wow.
Right.
Because the Jews are so special.
Not good enough.
Yeah, not good enough. Can you imagine?
He had this one girl that was really hot, but she wasn't Jewish, and he broke it off with her because she wasn't Jewish.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I didn't even mention her to my parents. I was with her for like 9 months.
She never met your parents?
No.
What? No. Not Jewish.
That's a good thing.
You gotta marry a Jewish girl. I don't get that.
That's a good thing. That's why the world is still spinning.
Nice.
So, wait a second.
Yes.
You didn't check out that chick was totally digging you?
I totally didn't read that, no.
Okay, all right, whatever.
Married man.
Hey, do me a favor.
Yeah, what?
First of all, answer one question about your wedding.
Reading glasses.
Why didn't you say your own vows?
Because,
you knew how corny they were? No.
He knew what a lie they were. They made the rabbi read the vows.
Didn't think you could make it sound believable?
No, of course I can, but first of all, vows are...
But first of all, you got to understand this guy with Judaism.
Oh,
it's so funny.
Yeah, go ahead.
On Yom Kippur, he was in a temple for 6 hours. He went 4 hours for regular services, 2 hours for, what is it?
For Kol Nidre.
What?
And I said to him, what are you doing?
Kol Nidre?
Yeah, 6 hours he's in temple. I go, what are you doing in there for 6 hours? Like,
is that a party?
I go, do you really believe? He goes, no, you know. I think he's like superstitious.
Yom Kippur is the highest holiday where you atone for your sins and remember the dead.
You're the Jewish Jew I know.
Hey, Howard.
Well, he must believe in it. Otherwise, he could marry anybody he wanted.
So he's so Jewish. You got to hear this. So the rabbi comes up to him and says, "We want to give you an aliyah," which means you get
a week before at Rosh Hashanah,
which usually means you get to go up and open the ark or something where they keep the Torah,
yeah, get it out and all that.
So Doug doesn't realize it. The rabbi wants him to read something in Hebrew, like a whole prayer.
Not only read, sing. I haven't done that since my bar mitzvah, or whatever, 17 years ago.
So he's freaking out, telling the rabbi, "No way!" He gets up on stage. Luckily for him, they had it in English and phonetics.
I didn't know what I was doing.
Dude, how could you be such a Jew and not know how to read Hebrew?
He didn't realize
I haven't done that. I haven't done that prayer since my bar mitzvah.
Which one, Baruch Hu Es Adonai?
Yeah,
that one. You don't know that one?
Well, I know.
How could you be? How could you spend 6 hours in a temple and not know Baruch Hu Es Adonai Hamvarach?
Yeah, but do you know the rest of it? Go ahead.
Baruch Hu Es Adonai Hamvarach. Baruch Hu Es Adonai Hamvarach Li'olam Va'eh. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher Kidshanu B'Mitzvot David.
How could you not?
How the hell could you not know that?
Well,
it's
different when they go up there and sing it.
Even if you were a moron.
No, I know that much, but there's another.
Oh, the second verse.
Yeah, there's another verse of that.
I mean,
panic attack.
I don't see how you spend 6 hours in a temple and not know that. I mean, I'm not even a believer, and I know that.
Right. You don't go to temple, huh?
Never.
Never, really?
Please. What? And you're a hypocrite. Do you go all year, or you just go
that
one time?
That's why I go and spend so much time in the holiday school. I'd like to go a lot
more
than I
go. You're trying to do it all in one fell swoop.
Yeah, well, that's...
Dude, how ridiculous is that?
It's like part-time Judaism.
It's crazy. Yeah. You're cramming.
Yeah, but it makes me feel good. It makes me feel good.
Well, if it makes you feel good,
funny,
what do you think is going to happen? You think really God is sitting there evaluating you? Tell the truth. Tell me you buy into that.
You got to believe.
Do you believe Scientology?
It's so funny.
No, absolutely not.
And why do you believe this?
Because it's the way
it
was.
The real one.
So funny because, you know, the rabbi.
This is the real deal?
You know, there's no right to be said here, so I'm going
to
plead the fifth here.
Doug and Marlo, now you're creating a Jewish household.
Yeah, I heard that part.
You know what's funny?
All I know is he had that wife like a ball and chain at Lotus around his neck. I loved it. I love to see that. I love it.
You heard
that's
the
my boy.
Chains clinking.
Oh, yeah, the marriage is going well. Hey, so wait a second.
Yes.
Take us back now to your wedding.
Where are those vows? Have you got them?
No, the vows will not be read on the air.
Come on.
Read your vows. What was your vow? Tell everyone your vow.
You wrote it.
Because it was almost, it was so childlike. I couldn't believe it.
It was like a 7th grader.
Yeah, we all turned to each other and said, it was like 2 7th graders getting married.
Give me one reason to read it right now. And what benefit do I have besides getting ridiculed, mocked, and scorned?
None.
Well, you already did it once.
You should be proud of it.
I am proud of it, but not.
What's your vow?
To this
do you remember it?
Vaguely.
Go ahead, give us the gist.
Just saying that I want to continue to build our relationship.
That was what you said.
Little lady.
Yeah. Go ahead.
There's no right to be said. You're going to kill me. You're going to make fun of me no matter what.
No, I'm not. Yeah. So far, I haven't.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I know it. I just don't want to say it. I'm just going to get
Marlo, you're the greatest girl.
She's the greatest girl I met. Yes, I love her. And I love our relationship. And
we have
continue
the
to build and grow.
Great.
That's right. All that.
Why is
what
she so great?
Vows cannot be misconstrued.
Why is she so great?
Vows are goofy.
Why is she so great?
Because she's just a great person all around.
Yeah.
And it was like there's nothing wrong with her. And
wasn't there something like you
so
understand me?
Yeah. Can you imagine?
We have perfect chemistry.
What are you making in that lab?
I could read way into that lab.
All right. Listen, good for you, Doug Goodstein. Now.
You won't read his vows. I can't believe you're ashamed.
I'm not ashamed of it.
Then read them.
You're ashamed. Admit you're ashamed. How can you say you're not ashamed?
I'm not ashamed of it. It's just...
Why? Who cares if we're
what benefit do I have?
Read your vows if you're not ashamed.
And be made fun of and then have the
what
audience call in and stop making fun.
If you're so proud.
I am proud.
The entertainment value would be immense.
My vows were to the people at the wedding and to my family and to... That's it.
Come on, let us hear it again. We missed it.
Say it every day.
All right, I will get the vows.
Good.
Okay.
If Marlo could read hers, that would be great.
Hers was great, too.
Yeah.
How much? Money talks.
No.
Oh, here we go. Didn't we just pay? We went to that
all right. Yeah, no. I will get the vows. I'll read them. You want me to...
Yeah, it's funny because they're very childish.
But I'm reading mine.
It's almost like little kids' concept of love.
It's Doug and Marlo sitting in a tree.
Yeah. Two young, two go, four girls.
Yeah.
I really, really like you.
And you really, really like me.
You are the greatest.
I am great. All right, it's fun. Good, seriously, congratulations.
Do you want me to get the vows?
Yes. Please.
Please.
Okay.
We would love it.
Okay.
That would be something to look forward to. Okay. We're a couple of minutes away from speaking to a man over the phone who got into a fight with Mr. Oprah Winfrey Stedman. Oh, he's here? Great.
He's here? I wanted to hear about this.
Yeah, he said he got into a fight with him.
He claims that Stedman turned into an animal.
Tomorrow, Big Gay John the Artist. He says he's going to sue. Big Gay John the Artist, Bill Maher, David Allen Coe coming soon, Carmen Electra, and the return of the Insane Clown Posse. By the way, October 20th is National Mammography Day. If you'd like to have a breast exam, call us at 1-800-44-STERN, and I'll do one.
You don't have a mammogram.
Yeah. I don't have a mammogram, but I can touch them and see if you have lumps. I can feel for lumps. I ain't saying I know what I'm doing.
You know you can feel, though.
I know I can feel. And if I feel something, I'll tell you. So give us a call, 1-800-44-STERN, if you want to come down here on the 20th. Don't forget our big Halloween promotion coming up. We are going to hide a porn star somewhere in the tri-state area. If you find her, she's yours. That's right, sex with a porn star. Oh. Could you imagine that? Jeez. It's going to be a mad dash around this town. Halloween's going to be like no other. Well, it's about time adults had fun on Halloween.
All right.
We'll be back right after this. Hey, did you really write your own vows, Dougie? Because Doug's going to read his vows right now. Then we're going to meet to the guy who got into a fight with Mr. Oprah Winfrey, Stedman Graham. Go ahead, what?
Yeah, of course I wrote them myself.
You did? Because
no,
the rabbi read them.
So?
Did you have to run them by Marlo before you read them?
No, of course not.
The first time she heard them?
I was just saying that he was also, Justice of the Peace offered to read his vows.
Yeah, but so Fred's a freak.
No, it's a pretty standard thing, I guess.
No.
Do you want to read your own vows or do you want us to want me to?
No, it's, you know what? If you're going to take vows, wouldn't you want to take the vow?
Well, yeah, we were planning on doing it. I didn't know there was an option when he said, do you want me to read them or are you going to read them? I said,
you want to know the truth? Yeah. My wedding, 100 years ago, I was 23 years old.
You read them?
I read them. My wife wrote them. In fact, my mother-in-law and my wife wrote them. I never had anything to do. I said, I don't know what. I have no vow. I put no thought into the whole thing. I just got married. Know what I was doing?
I wouldn't be proud of that.
No, I'm not. But I was like, I don't want to get up and read stuff. I said, if you guys write it, I'll. And they were like, I promise to love you.
But you had to say them.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Oh, yeah.
Did she cry?
No. She wrote them. How could she cry?
Did you cry? She knew exactly what was going to happen.
Your wife was crying a little.
No, she wasn't.
You
wouldn't
was
she?
You married Doug.
All right, read your vows. You got to hear
I
these.
I think she was laughing, too. She was having a laugh with
Here's Doug Goodstein's. Do you have Marlo's also?
No, I'm not reading Marlo's. If she wants to read them, she can read them.
I see. Respect your wife. Yeah, okay. Yeah. All right.
Here we go. This is my favorite.
This is great. Go ahead.
Okay. As I enter into marriage with you, I promise to even further expand. That's so beautiful. My love and devotion towards you in everything we do.
Yeah. It's so childish.
Why is that? Okay, I'll continue. I'll continue.
Explain it to him, Robin.
I will always be there for you as your husband and best friend. I will continue to show you the utmost care, loyalty, trust, and affection.
Already you're breaking that vow.
Right. Saturday night you were breaking that vow.
I was not. Stop me.
Go ahead.
You are truly the most incredible person I've ever met, and the times we have spent together.
Dude, who's more incredible, me or your wife? Be honest. Go ahead, yeah.
And the times we have spent together have been incredible, and I will be sure to continue to make all our endeavors even better now and forever.
So you just vowed to your wife that you're going to love her for the rest of your life and be her best friend.
I'm not done yet.
All right, go ahead.
All my love, always, Doug. You are my schnooky wookie pookie.
Is that what you said?
Of course not, you nut. No.
Oh, I'm a nut.
I believe that.
No, yeah.
No, that's it. Oh, it ends at all my love, always, Doug.
It's like what you write.
Everything is... I love you so much, and you've made life so wonderful, and I intend to keep
making
it wonderful. Because,
dude, you know that that's not true. It's not all so wonderful. It's not all so great.
How do you know that?
Because I know you, and I know what you're up to.
And you're in my apartment, in my private life with
No, I just know. I know you outside of the apartment, and that's the point.
And what do I do outside the apartment? Bang.
Dude, it's not all... No, it's not that you're banging anyone else. It's not all that great. It's going to be work. You're not going to love her every minute. You're kidding yourself.
Why is she so great? Because of how you feel or because of who she is?
She's just a great person.
No, answer my question. What? Because of how you feel or who she is?
Because it's both.
No, it isn't. You know it is. It's because of how you feel. And the moment your feelings change, she's not going to be so great.
Yeah, exactly. It's like those vows are like what you write in your sixth grade graduation book.
That's right.
Now you go back and write new vows.
No. No, I'm not going to let your rhetoric change my opinion of getting out of a marriage.
She's the greatest girl he's ever seen.
All I know is, bro, I'm going to read those back to you in 5 years when we're at the divorce.
And we're going to laugh together.
That's not very nice.
All right, get out of here.
What? I mean, you got to be realistic. There's,
no,
I'm
you
realistic.
Be realistic.
No, no, I'm.
You're the one who's out of touch.
No, I mean, yes, I know the stats that 50% of marriages don't work out. I mean,
yeah, but be realistic.
Scary.
If
it's
couples
scary.
Had a more realistic view of marriage, the vows wouldn't sound like that.
That's right.
But how else?
Here's a vow.
Vows are. Yeah, let me hear yours. Robin, you write some
All right,
vows.
Here's
too.
Your vow you should have said to Marlo.
Just in case Mr. X.
I am an insecure guy. I'm afraid that I'm not going to be able to hold on to you unless I marry you at this point. So the reason I'm marrying you is
that's
to...
That's Howard's vow.
The reason I'm marrying you
Howard
is
vow.
Because you're a good friend to me. You seem to want to go everywhere I want to go. That's but in a couple true. Of years, it could very easily change.
No, Doug's should be, I feel great when I'm with you, and as long as I feel great when I'm with you, I'll
stay with
be
you.
Because
there's no
vow.
Way... There's no way Doug's at the hard work. All right, get out of here now that we've wrecked your marriage. Right, get out.
F you both.
Oh.
Your vow should have been, with any luck, this won't totally suck. Now get out. Get out and never show your face
here
again.
I'm Robin's ready for vows. The hard work.
What are Robin's vows?
X, please field my phone call.
All right. Now, you got to hear this. Well, I'll save it for tomorrow because I see we're running out of time. I was going to talk about Benji and Casey and a whole bunch of different things that are going on here around.
Are you sure you have time to wait? Casey sounds like he's in trouble.
Casey, come in here for a real quick second.
He needs an intervention. Did you ever sit down and have that talk with him you said you were going to have?
No, I didn't. I should. I want to do it in a serious manner. All right, what is this I hear? Your car. The guy from the garage called and said that he was holding on to your car until you paid him $100?
No, I stole it back.
Yeah, what does that mean? You how did you steal your car back? You owe a guy $100.
No, I owed him more than that. I bounced the check, right?
For how much?
It turns out it's $500.
All right.
So I go in there to get my car out, and I'm going to leave it. Now I'm going back to leave it back on Long Island because it's cost me money, which I don't have to keep it here. And I never use it, right? So I get rid of it, and he says, "No, you can't have your car until you give me $500 cash." So I said, look, the banks are closed. It's Saturday afternoon. Even if I had $500 cash, I couldn't get it for you anyway. Here's a check. Give me my car. He wouldn't give me my keys. So I
Do you blame him?
Yeah.
Why?
I said, here's a check. Here you go. You got my social security
You're
number.
Already bounced
you got all my information.
But you bounced the check.
I don't care. It happens all the time. You send it back to the bank. It's a $15 surcharge.
I know
that. And I get
that,
nailed for it. And you do it again. It happens.
He wants his money. He's not going to give up.
So you do it like when you run a business. Now you do it. You send it back in. You get another shot. You get two tries.
No, the guy is going to hold on to the car because he can't get his money.
No, he can't. He's got my address. He's got all my information. I don't care.
He's got all his collateral.
I don't give a crap. You think he's the only one that
how did
got...
you get? How did you get your car back?
So I go to my girlfriend. I said, look, I got a spare key next to the microphone.
His girlfriend is beautiful. I can't believe she, they're like Bonnie and Clyde now.
No, she's great. She was so good. She was so good at it, too. I'm like, all right, go back into the apartment. Just give me the key. Don't let anybody see it. I had an extra key. Put it in my pocket and then go back there and I'll pick you up in a couple minutes. So she goes back and she gives me the key, right? So I yell at the guy. And at this point, I'm ready to kill him. He doesn't speak English or anything like that.
Right.
So she goes back up there, and he's got me blocked in. So as soon as he goes back to help another customer, I run back there. I get in my car, and I peel out. I see this guy running after me and stuff. Hey, come back. I'm like, yeah, see you later, pal.
Wow.
Pick up my girlfriend, and I'm gone.
How much money do you owe this guy?
$500.
Here's $500.
No, get out of here. I ain't expecting that.
No, I mean, what are you doing? You owe the guy money.
So what? Big deal. I owe a lot of people money.
Hey, you'll pay me back.
No.
Here, go pay this guy.
No,
you're acting
you.
Like a retard.
Nice
you.
You that's
don't
nice you, but no, that's okay.
And I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to sit you down and have a talk with you.
I don't need to talk.
I think you're
going to
stop
about?
Gambling.
Dude, I don't gamble. I don't gamble that much. Look, here's the thing. I don't make enough money to pay my rent unless I do appearances. And I'm not doing appearances. I haven't been doing one in a while, so I'm stuck this month. Next month, it'll be better.
All right.
He blew Gary up for a paying job.
Now, didn't Gary call you this week and say he'd give you $100 to help move a few things?
Yeah, that was the same day.
That you were stealing the car.
Yeah, I couldn't get out of that. I had to go back and drop my car off.
But you had an opportunity to make money. Could have made $100.
Yeah, also, oh, here's another thing. I got no license. I got no registration. I got no insurance, and I'm driving around in that car.
Why do you think you trained like you were supposed to?
Because I had to drop my car off, idiot. What, are you not listening?
Why'd you have to drop your car off?
Because it's cost me money to leave it here in the city.
Another day wasn't going to kill you. You're already fired.
Yeah, it is. No, because it just rolled over. The end of the month just ended. If I didn't get it out, I got to pay for another one.
You could have stolen it on Sunday.
Well, yeah, I'll pay for it.
No, Howard, that's nice of you, but I'm not accepting it. No way.
I think what he's saying is the $500 won't help him, really.
No, it will.
Because he's got problems all over.
Yeah, but he won't take your money. I mean, I've offered him money in the past. He borrowed $20 from me last week and kept it for like a day. I was like, don't worry about it. He won't take money from you. When he does, he wants to pay back right away.
Yeah, I understand that, but this is crazy.
He won't pay the people he actually owes, though.
Can I tell you something? Can I tell you how kooky Casey is? He's at a time where he's been without cash, but he's had checks in his hand. And the only bank that Casey can go to is in all the way out on Long Island, like way far out there.
Yeah.
He won't go to a regular bank that has chains.
Yeah.
It's just this one. And I said to Casey, listen, Casey, I'll give you the $500. You go there on the weekend, you'll cash a check and just give it to me. I can't take your money. I can't handle that.
No. So how come if he offers you a paying job, you should have made you
No, I had to get my car back. And by the time the whole thing was over, they kept me there the whole time. I could do. Hey, but listen to this. I'm sorry. I forgot what I was going to say.
All right, it's enough. I'm bored. I don't believe your problems. You got to learn to live within your means. That's all.
You know, live within my means. What do I do?
What do you make here?
I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
I'll tell you about going number two in my pants and doing all that stuff. It's so embarrassing. I won't tell you how much I make.
Why? Because you're embarrassed?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
Does he make over 19?
Yes.
Huh.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to sit Casey down. I'm going to go through all his finances with him because he talks to me about that. I'm going to go through what he pays for rent and I know how much he makes. And then we're going to sit down and see if we can't get like a budget thing going. Because there's something that's not making sense.
Yeah, Howard. I mean, like, you know, you realize $500 got to be 2 months. It can't be just.
No, it's a month and a half.
Here's Jose from your parking lot. Is a guy named Jose? Jose.
Yes, this is Jose. You tell the pastor to see he owe me money.
See?
I'm not even playing no more. He owe me a tip too, you bastard.
Oh, you owe me a tip. All right, let's go to the news.
Howard, but thank you for your offer. That's nice of you.
I'm almost going to tell him he should probably start looking for another job. Because I love the guy, but he can't make a living
here. You know, there also is something called a part-time job if you don't make enough at your regular job.
What the hell am I going to do that?
Imagine you go to the Gap on 86th Street and there's Casey.
Yo, when I first took this job, when I first took this job, I used to bounce on the weekends every once in a while at a bar.
Yeah.
Right? So imagine I do that now.
Why not?
Hey, you're that gay guy from TV. Yeah, you're not going to let me in. I'll get in like 5 fights every night.
All right.
Aren't you TV's Casey Armstrong?
Yeah.
Hey, I was the power test polar bear for a little while for some extra cash.
What is that?
You go out on the street, like dressed as a polar bear, and wave to the cars that go.
Hey, I'll do that in a minute.
Is that right?
I'd love to do that.
I filled in for a friend of mine once for some extra cash. It was like $50 for the day.
Wow.
I had the world's most dangerous job, Howard. I guarantee it. I delivered chicken to Roosevelt at midnight.
Oh.
Casey, couldn't you do that?
I'd love to do that.
What is it?
You know what Casey could do that Stuttering John used to do? He used to wear T-shirts and then charge people on the Channel 9 show.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
Chico's bail bonds.
But, you know, John and Ganji and all these guys have lived on Casey's salary before.
All right.
Well, part of it stems from the fact, again, because I know all the chain of people have been in Casey's position. Casey refuses to have a roommate. That's a big problem.
Oh,
I already signed in, and plus you pay the broker's fee. It's going to cost me a lot more to find another place.
I don't know. He always has a problem.
He doesn't know how to. He doesn't know how to manage his money.
What are you talking about, dude? You have no idea.
He told me what he paid in rent, and it's like what I pay in rent.
Right.
I mean, he's out of his mind.
Hey, wake up, man! You can't find another. Place.
Ganji pays half as much.
He lives with a roommate. Yeah. I don't know anybody.
Oh, you don't know. You can't find a roommate.
No.
Come on.
Oh, come on.
And also, he's paid some ridiculous fees to brokers, which a guy at his level really shouldn't have to do. In fact, he went to a broker, gave the guy a fee, changed his mind, left that fee with the broker, like a lot of money.
Scott, the engineer, you have something to add to this?
He could work for Rocket Entertainment. He could be my roadie.
And what do you pay for that?
Oh, I did that once.
Yeah.
What do you pay?
I pay like $100 a gig.
And really? It's worth the price of entertainment, kids. Yeah. I promise.
And you can get attacked by little kids, too.
Scott's DJ business. Yeah. You could be his cod. You know what? I'd rather be broke.
You see, he thinks he's too good for that.
I know he does.
I think I'm too good? What are you, crazy?
What? Well, you didn't work for Gary.
What are you talking about? You have no idea what you're talking about.
All right,
would you work for Scott?
Would I work for Scott? Yeah, I don't give a crap. What is $100? What's $100 going to do for me, though?
Oh, there you go.
Is that going to get me out of debt?
I don't know. Here's the big dilemma. You know what? Casey and I spoke about this yesterday.
You do it five times, you got $500.
Right. Here's Casey's big dilemma.
Oh, okay, go ahead, bro.
Casey's a straight man, right? We're pretty sure about that.
Right.
So, okay, there's a place on
Long
Island.
I don't know if he knows that.
Escapes, you know, on Saturday nights they do the Mail Review show.
Yeah, fine.
So they ask Casey to be a judge in the Mail Review, and he's like, I would never do it, but he's going to do it.
Of course you should do it. What do they pay?
I know, he'll turn down good money.
No, you know.
What do they pay?
I'm doing it.
You're not gay, dude. Don't worry about it.
I know, but I'm going to be a judge at this place.
So what do you pay? I mean, what do they pay?
I'm not going to tell you how much they pay me, but it's nice.
So then do it. Are you stupid?
I am doing it. This came about yesterday, but dude, I mean, you know what? I'm a man. You know what I'm saying?
I was thinking about this
you're
before.
A man. You're an idiot.
No, you're broke is what you are.
You've already marched in Chicago's gay pride parade.
I know.
I mean, you're lucky they don't include that you have to have gay sex with these guys.
Hey, Howard.
What are you talking about?
You're so broke.
You're lucky they don't put you in the review.
Yeah.
I know. It's just like, you know, I'm like a whore. I'm like, all right, what do you want me to do? I'll do it. You know what I mean?
God, welcome to the real world.
Right, yeah. Well, you know what? Guess what? We all had to do weird stuff.
Yeah.
What do you think? What do you think I did when I made $96 a week? You know what I did? I took a job on a weekend spinning records at the Elmsford Hotel, and people made fun of me.
I did an appearance with Barney, and he outdrew me.
I was a rodeo clown.
I went to a record store, got kicked in the nuts by a 13-year-old.
Why?
Because I said, your mother looks hot. Is that her in the parking lot?
I got thrown in the mud by a bunch of listeners. I got thrown in the mud and rolled around. I'm at the Square Garden.
Hey, me and Robin did a tug of war on the lawn of a...
We opened grocery stores.
Yeah. We did a 5 and 10 also.
Tire shops. we would appear anywhere.
I appeared at racetracks.
I did the grand opening of Car Cash, which is a garage on the west side.
Right. Yeah, dude, you do stuff.
You do what you got to do, man.
Yeah, but you know, you're right. I understand that. I understand you got to do weird stuff, like doing the gay float and stuff.
And
like
by the way, you're not, like, you're lucky you're getting asked to do gay stuff. I mean, who the hell are you?
I'm not a gay guy.
But that's the point is, no one even knows who you are. You're lucky they're asking
you. I'm not a gay guy.
So what?
That's the point.
So what? So go judge a contest and have fun with it.
You know who did? You know who went through this? I'm not kidding. John Wayne Bobbitt went through a period of time where he couldn't make money, and John Wayne Bobbitt was dancing at gay clubs because the gay guys wanted to see his weird Franken penis.
Right.
And he.
I'm not Franken penis. I'm not a gay guy. So I mean,
neither is he. But he needed the money. You do what you got to do.
If you got to work and you need money.
Yeah.
I can
also fillet guys too.
Well,
you
could.
So that's a big step. That's a
big step. Yeah. That's you need to do that.
Hey, Case, how much are you in debt, honestly? If you total.
Total it up.
It's a
couple of G's.
It's quite a bit.
Like, over three grand?
I owe the bank some money, too.
Like, how much total? Do you have student loans and stuff?
I was on a football scholarship.
Oh. Thank
that was all free. He went to school for free.
It's hard to believe a guy who had a football scholarship could be in this much financial trouble.
So how much are you in debt, Case?
Yeah, what's your nut?
Couple of grand?
You know what? All I need is, I just need one good thing to happen to me, and I'm...
What?
I'm
one horse race?
That could happen, yeah, or I could get a, I don't know.
How much money do you owe?
Probably a couple grand.
Have you ever tried going to a sperm bank or a blood bank? And you could?
I've been thinking about it. In college, it was a place you could donate plasma, but I don't know if you could do that around here.
True, Jim.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
What do you get for that?
$75 a pint,
is
I think.
Is it really 75?
I don't know.
I would do that.
All right, we got to do the news.
Like that sounds high.
Because once again, the show is going very late. We haven't even started news, and it's 5 to 10. My hours are 6 to 10. I want to know how I can get in to get those done. Thank you, Scott, and that's a very generous offer, $100.
Casey's turn.
Hey, you know, I don't make that much to begin with.
I understand.
Well, where that came from.
10 gigs, $1,000.
It just rolls right up.
Then you buy a CD or a stock.
Music you could want.
One day all this could be yours.
Where's that power cord? I'm deducting it.
Casey, go to the car and give me my power cord.
No, you know what it is? It's watch the records while I eat.
Yeah. Oh, is that what he does?
Oh, it's the worst job.
What is the job?
Yeah, first you got to lift this DJ equipment down the stairs of this, like, narrow hallway. Yeah.
Oh, how depressing.
I'm almost saying. Then you load it up in his car.
Wait a minute. Do you have to be in a tuxedo when you're
Yeah. And then you get him in his car, and he's, like, got cigarettes all over the place. The ashtray filled with cigarettes.
It's so depressing.
He's sick from driving.
And how many hours do you have to stand there with him?
Then you got to stand with him for 2 hours, and you take turns eating. You got to watch him do hands off.
And you have to wear a tux and everything?
Yeah.
All that for $100?
Yeah, I know.
So can cheap. You get free food.
Yeah.
Oh.
You get free drinks.
You know.
Free drinks, John.
And you got to hang out with Scott.
Yeah, yeah. What good is drinking if you're with Scott?
Yeah,
you need to drink.
I'd rather drink alone.
And you get attacked by little kids, which is great.
$100. And you have to carry all the equipment.
Then you got to carry it home, drive home with them.
It's just being with Scott.
Wow.
A lot of fun.
Casey,
that's what I mean. Casey's got to learn to do anything.
You have your son help you?
My son has helped me, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, poor kid. That's child abuse.
That's what I think.
I'm training him. He's going to take over the business.
Do you still smoke? Or?
Yeah, he smokes.
Did he smack the smoke?
Oh, yeah, he stinks.
Oh, forget it. That car.
He smells.
You know Scott's got two cars now, too?
Yeah.
He has, like, a nice car and then a car he drives to work.
Yeah. Those guys for all that money know how to take care of a car.
That is so funny. The smelly car.
Oh, it reeks of cigarettes.
And
you know.
Stare at him, and he's all depressed. Yeah. And you got to talk to him all night.
Yeah, you got. It's just you and Scott the whole night.
Yeah, and then you got to carry stuff.
You have to carry his like big DJ box, all his records.
Well, what is a job? I mean, you know.
Well, for 2 hours, if you hired a movie company to move all that crap, they charge you a grand.
Yeah, right. I don't even make a call.
You're $100.
$100 for like what? About 7 hours.
And then you sit around for 4 hours.
That's 7 hours.
Yeah, it's like 2 hours loading and driving.
You maybe work 2 hours out of the whole day.
Right.
Yeah, but just sitting there with you is work. It's not like you're having fun.
No, I know, but you're not laboring that whole time.
So much better being a waiter.
Yeah, I mean, Alicia, you know, you definitely make more than you probably make $100 just to at least you know deal with you.
Hey, all right, let's take a break and then we'll come back and do the news.
Do you want to hear the essay that guy Casey?
That's what we were talking about.
All right. This is his first great.
Nobody wants to hear this.
Casey, come on in here. All right. So Casey, just to give you a story, Casey, I hired him right out of college. He was a football player from Kentucky State.
He perfectly reasonable, didn't he?
Good-looking guy, nice, well-mannered guy, and then I've come to find out he got in trouble in college. He beat up a guy, had to go to court, the whole thing.
Had to go to anger management classes.
And it turns out, from the time he was in first grade, he wrote an essay, and they put him in the school psychologist. And this is the essay.
When was the last time?
Well, that's, you know, one of them. That's the only one that I had.
When was the last time you hit somebody?
I was in college. I was Western Kentucky, by the way.
Oh, Western Kentucky.
Yeah.
Well, whatever.
Who cares? Yeah, who cares? Hey, let me ask you this. Is this the essay that got you in trouble?
Pretty much, yeah.
All right.
This is the start.
It's called A Tall Tale You Won't Believe.
Okay.
Right. It's hard to read because it's in pencil.
Your daughter's laughing at me, Howard.
Well, she's never... What is that? You're afraid to hear it?
I'm excited to hear it.
Oh, you are.
It's funny.
Once upon a time, there were three people. Kyle, Casey, and Armstrong.
Oh, my goodness.
Ready to lock him up. His name is...
I'm running for cover now.
Because your name is Kyle, Casey, Armstrong, right? Okay.
Cuff him.
And all of a sudden, a guy I saw... was eating a mouse. I went to Armstrong. So he was fishing in his pool. He was drunk.
Oh, man.
Hi, he said. Yeah, hi. So I got my fishing pole and put a monkey... with mustard on, and dropped it in the water. Oh, I got a nibble. Oh, no, I pulled too hard. All I got was bones. The skin and meat came off.
Whoa.
So next I caught a stingray, but it turned into an Indian. So I got out my knife, cut, cut, cut into little pieces. Cut, cut, cut. But soon he came after me. So I said, wait till you something. Then I got my... vacuum cleaner, and I got all the pieces of the Indian I cut up. Then I went, holy mackerel.
First
so now he chopped, yeah, he chopped the guy up. He chopped him up, and now he's vacuuming
monkey,
him.
And now he's chopping up an Indian.
So then I went to Kyle's house, and he had so many, he had 5 million cigarettes in his mouth. And when he saw me, he tried to spit at me. But I bludgeoned him.
Use the word bludgeon?
Or something like that. Or I blocked him. I bonked him.
You bonked him?
Kill, kill, kill. What wonder they locked you up.
They didn't lock you up hard?
What are you?
For like a first grade, that's not creative?
Oh, it's very creative.
Who knew the word drunk in first grade?
Yeah. I don't know.
Well, that's what I'm saying. He was drunk, 500 cigarettes. He's totally absorbed with weird
cigarettes, drinking, chopping up Indians and vacuuming them.
Why an Indian?
Yeah. What is it, Benji?
We're talking about in the office. I think he's trying to kill part of himself in first grade.
Who knows?
Kyle, Casey, and Armstrong.
He had three different personalities. He was a schizoid, and he was trying to kill one of his personalities and everything. like that.
Yeah, and that's coming from Benji, who's completely retarded.
Look, Benji walks in with a bat full of food.
You can't even walk around without food.
I remember that one.
Wow, dude. I can see why the teacher sent him down to the psycho.
Can you really? You don't think that was...
And then these little stick figure pictures of little sad boys and stuff? Like frowning?
Yeah, but Howard, I think that's creative.
Mm.
I don't think that's...
Yes, but you have to wonder what kind of a mind that kind of creativity...
Yeah, where does that come from?
You don't think of that stuff.
I like to send them to the school psychologist.
Like, you don't think about...
He's like, you don't think about killing Indians and vacuuming them up.
Never occurred to me.
Kill, kill, kill.
Give her the evidence. Jump up tunnel.
Because right. This isn't even like somebody's doing something to you. You're just walking around cutting and killing.
Yeah.
Well, it was just, you know, just things that were happening.
You're trying to cult mafia, dude.
No, I'm not. I would never hurt anybody, you know.
Except for the guy you kicked in the nuts the guy you bludgeoned outside of the bar.
No, I treat people the way they treat me.
Oh, boy. Okay. That's a little overreacting.
Here, here's some Rammstein for you.
Yeah.
I'll throw a little Rammstein on the...
cue it up.
Calm you down, man. I don't want to see you blow. Yeah, calm down, boy.
The soothing one, right there.
Who do you like better, Casey, Armstrong, or Kyle? Imagine you're American and you're listening to this.
No.
You don't like this?
This one I don't like.
But it gets cool, though.
This one does not rock.
It gets there.
That sounds like French to me, the cowardly language. I won't allow my children to learn French.
What language did they take?
Any language but that.
The rechlechen, the Jews in the oven. Throw them in the oven and cook them up good. We should have won World War II. I'll kill the Jews. You kill the Schwarzes. The Jews. Hitler had the right idea.
Guys playing drums with human bones. Monkey bones and fish.
And cutting up
Indians. Cutting up people and Indians and vacuuming them. I'll take the Indians, cut them into pieces. Vacuum, vacuum, vacuum of the Indians. I can make a song out of Casey's and sing. Take on those fishing, half a million cigarettes on kill, kill, kill. A drunken Indian. There's a sky you won't believe. Cut up my classmates. Feed them to the fish. Revenge for my father making me wrestle. Kick the boy in the schoolyard in the nuts. Kick him in the nuts.
Break a nose, break a leg.
Break a leg. I like to work out all day. Make my abs into a six-pack. Screw up Howard's lunch every day.
Charles Manson just called. He wants to meet KC.
That's right.
Yeah, he likes it.
Like to join his family.
Yeah. Yeah, Matt, what is it?
Hey, Howard, you got to fire all three of those guys, Kyle, Casey, and Armstrong.
Yeah, immediately.
Mock Snell, man. Mock Snell.
Snell. Many times I've been alone with a woman, and many times they try to steal my wallet. So I won't get undressed. I love steroids and creatine. A gal invited me into a hot tub in New Orleans, and I wouldn't go. That's very nice.
I think you might have a hit there, Howard.
Why doesn't my softy work?
All right.
You're killing me, man.
I like men. I hate women. I hate my penis.
You ain't right, man.
What is it, Ken?
Yes, hey, how you doing, Al?
Hey, how are you?
How you doing? I'm a psychologist, and I'd like to say a couple things about Casey's extremely disturbing story.
Please. What's your problem?
What do you got to say about it?
Yeah, don't give me a crap.
Who are you?
I'll kick you.
Okay, well, first of all, as probably been said about these boys from Colorado, violence to animals is the number one predictor of violence to humans.
Right.
And that's a pretty violent story with the using the monkey as bait.
Yeah, he was first grade and then stripping the skin off the monkey.
Very disturbing.
And then
very disturbing stuff.
Really? Seriously?
Absolutely.
Wow.
100%. And I mean, just think about it. I mean, when you were in first grade, did you have thoughts anywhere close to as violent as that?
As Jackie said, I didn't even know about drinking. I didn't know about killing monkeys. I would never think about killing a monkey. I would never think about chopping up an Indian and putting him in a vacuum cleaner.
And you got to wonder. I mean, you got to wonder what was going on at home, if there was violence at home, if there was an alcoholic at home.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm thinking.
Was your dad an alcoholic?
No.
Mom?
No.
Oh, you don't want to
talk? My mom's a saint.
Yeah.
Well, he had to know about it from somewhere.
Uncle? Where'd you learn about drinking in first grade?
I probably watched TV.
You know,
TV.
This other thing is my mom's a saint. My mom's a saint.
Oh, yeah.
My mom's a saint.
Well, she is.
My mom's a saint. Yeah. My mom's a saint.
Yeah. Well, that's what a lot of gay men say.
I would chop her up.
Well, I had a rabbit. I had dogs.
I boiled them. Ate them.
I was kind of animal. I love animals, man. I would never hurt them. I was vegetarian for a year and a half.
Right.
And then I ate the rabbit.
Yeah, Sean, you're on the air.
I ran out of pets.
Hey, how's it going, Howard?
Hey, dude.
Hey, I got this thing that's really going to prove that it was destined to be that he'd be violent in college. When I was in third grade, I wrote a story, and there's a journal entry talking about one of my co-students, and I was telling everybody about how gorgeous he was and how nice he was to me, and he's beautiful and kept me from getting beat up by the other kids, and, well, now I'm a fag.
Right, you did. Well, there you go.
So there you go.
Good for you. Okay, thank you.
I'll meet you down by the pond.
All right, when we come back, Robin, I am going to introduce you to my adopted son.
All right.
Of course, today is Daddy Thursday. No, it's take your daughter to work day.
Yeah, and you decided to bring your son as well.
I brought my son, too. I've never revealed this before, but years ago, like Steven Spielberg, I was the original person to adopt black children.
So they're all copying you.
Yeah. My son now is a little older. He's here to celebrate his 19th birthday.
Really? 19?
That's right. 19 years old. He's a good boy. LeVar. LeVar Stern. And I'm ready to reveal it to the world. I'm going to do that right after. What is it?
Your son's in the bathroom, so we'll take a break.
I'm going to take a break.
See?
You ever listen to this show?
I am listening to Howard. Tom was talking to me.
Okay. I'm glad. Maybe you're tuned to another station.
Don't embarrass me in front of your daughter.
We were talking about Gary's new hairstyle, me and Ralph, the other day.
Yeah.
He says it's all wrong for Gary's face because it's so straight now, the hair.
It's all wrong for
it makes his head,
it makes his whole face look bigger.
Everybody, there's not a soul that told me they didn't like it.
Really?
You and Robin, who were too busy focusing on my teeth, my ass, and everything else.
His lips are bigger than his hair.
Right. You have more lips than you do hair.
You put your head upside down.
And you have more Adam's apple than you have face, but hey, you get
so what? Come on, be honest.
I am honest.
But what I do is try to create a hairstyle that will at least hide my flaws. What you're doing is you're like putting a neon sign out there. I have lips and big teeth.
I'm comfortable with who I am.
All right.
I don't have to hide anything.
There is nothing you can do.
Right.
There's not enough head.
No, the hair is
There's
nice.
There's not enough head for the lips.
The hair is fine. The face is too big.
But, you know, he has, like, at the top. He has a normal head.
Right.
It just grows out from the bottom.
I'm just watching Deborah looking at me, evaluating whether this is true or not.
Deborah, what do you think?
I don't know.
What do you think? Do you think his lips and teeth are too big?
No.
You know.
Look at those teeth. Look at aren't they big?
Take a good look.
This is the good daughter.
Aren't they big teeth?
No. Yes.
No, they are. Listen,
she's a very polite
kid. Deborah, I admit that my teeth are on the large side. I don't deny it.
Well, okay. All right. Enough of that. You don't need to be humiliated.
But would you stop? Let me ask you. Hey, Deborah, I admit my teeth are on the large side, but if you saw me walking down the street, would you stop and elbow your girlfriend and go, my God, look at the size of that guy's teeth?
No.
She's too busy walking around your head.
All right. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back right after these words. Hey, Casey, when you played football, did you get naked for the showers and stuff in front of men?
Of course.
man.
You didn't?
He's a guy involved in the horseplay. This horseplay among guys like him.
You like to be naked and have horseplay.
Some of the guys would be naked and would be fighting each other.
Like a bona fight?
Like no, like the some of the black guys would like fist fight each other.
Or naked. Horseplay.
It was weird, but the weirdest thing was we had stalls next to each other, like the dumpers.
Hmm.
You know, so you'd be sitting next to your friend, and he'd be reading the paper like, yo, give him the sports section. And then you'd flush him because he smelled real bad. Like, dude, flush. You smell, you're terrible.
You know? Do you have a nice size wiener?
I think I'm nice.
Yeah.
When you get out, when practice is like 20 degrees, and you got your jock on, you take your jock off, sometimes the indentation of the jock would be on your pin, you know what I'm saying? And it would be cold out, so you'd be real small.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes.
I'm sorry, there was a whole group of guys when I played that were the jocks that didn't care about being naked and were so proud of being naked that they would just do regular stuff naked.
Like
don't
walk around naked.
Guys?
Eat naked. Yeah.
Fight naked.
And they act like they have clothes on.
Right.
Yeah. And some of the guys like...
wrestle naked. Right. That's a strange area.
They that was weird. Naked.
It was weird. Sometimes two guys would get into it.
They didn't even get aroused?
In the shower. And they would be like wrestling around. Kinda, and everybody would be around yelling at him like, yo, kick his ass.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, right.
In the shower.
How about feel his ass?
Right.
Rub his ass.
That's a great ass.
You're not doing it right. Let me.
So muscular.
And sometimes when the guys would be leaving, you'd throw a little soap on them so they'd have to come back and wash it off.
Mm.
You know, on the day after my wedding, you know, Jackie slept over at my house.
Yeah.
And right in the middle of the living room is maybe a couple of guys. He just like takes off his clothes, changes, you know, totally naked.
Yeah.
I could never do that.
He doesn't care.
It's so normal.
Yo, you were talking about taking number two. It's a little bit off topic, but when I went down for homecoming, Buckethead was in one of those porta potties, and everyone was lined up to go to the bathroom. Right?
Right.
So nobody takes a number two in a porta potty, right?
Never.
But this kid did. So we opened the door on him.
Not gay, don't worry.
And like everybody's waiting to go and take a pee and we're saying, he's like, that's real funny, guys.
Buckethead was moving his mouth. And they opened the door.
It was the first we started kicking it and stuff like that. He's like, hey, real funny, guys, you're such dicks.
Casey was probably the kid who would beat do all the games in the shower, towels.
I guarantee
I saw Casey, I saw a videotape of Casey used to go around with his buddies. Describe that.
What?
Did you ever see this? You gotta watch this.
Oh, no.
He's such a nut. Describe
it? What we did was we took condoms, we filled them with ranch dressing,
right?
And we ran out of town, and we would throw them at people, would ask them for directions, and throw them in their face.
Oh.
And this one guy got out of the truck, and this one was sitting in the park.
Old lady.
It was bad. And then he gets up, and he slips it down the back of his shirt.
Oh.
And you see her in slow motion pulling the thing out. And it's like all this ranch dressing spritz all over the place. And she's holding the condom in her hand.
I saw the tape of it.
You know what
it's criminal. It's bordering on criminal.
It was Jackass before Jackass was on.
Oh, my God.
You know
what's
weird about that?
Yeah, he took a condom with ranch dressing. She pulled out the condom. It was dripping all down.
But, Howard, you know what's weird about that? I remember Casey brought that in. And he thought that this was the funniest tape that ever existed.
Yes.
And everybody started going, you know, that's not right. And all of a sudden Casey was like, well, it was those other guys that did it.
He was taking credit for it. I don't know, man. It don't look right.
Yeah. And another time, these guys were playing tennis, this guy and his wife. And what we used to do is we used to hide in the bushes and make, like, those sounds. You know, like when you hit the ball and stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know, like girly sounds. So whatever the guy would hit the ball, like, ah! You know, like that. And finally, the guy got so mad, he threw his racket down and chased us.
Oh, that's funny.
That's funny.
That's funny.
That's funny.
And then we had this other...
Although the ranch dressing one is kind of funny,
don't want to have that Dundee.
That little old lady looked real sad.
You know, Casey's so weird. He turned me onto a show on the Learning Channel that I've been TiVoing. That's amazing.
Yeah. It's not the Learning Channel. It's TLC.
That's right.
Okay, you ready for this? It's called People Out of Control. Right. And every week it's him with the ranch dressing, except it's not. You know, it's stuff like that.
Yeah.
They showed some guys who got a paint gun and just started driving around whacking people. Okay, so it's the best show. And it I tape it every funny. Week. It's wild.
On the Learning Channel, he must do it under the premise that it's all wrong.
Oh, yeah, but still, he's watching it because it's
Is there a narrator going,
yes.
We're looking at people who are completely out of control.
In this segment, we see people who get really out of control. And then what they do is between segments to make idiots like Casey feel bad about themselves, they get
immorality.
A shrink.
Yeah, shrink.
They get a shrink. And
this person is not
tells you what's
normal.
Wrong with them.
They're angry at society and angry at their own parents.
So really Casey's, what this person should do is...
Yeah. And now let's look at the tape of a man who threw condoms down an old lady's back filled with ranch dressing.
Yeah, you should submit your tape.
Yeah, because what's on that show is not off the mark at all.
Yeah, right.
The ranch
thing. See, like my friends
you should submit that tape.
I know my friends want to do it now. They say, hey, let's go throw cherry tomatoes at people. I'm like, dude, we're 25 years old. We get arrested now.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, one more. This guy was laying.
Let's go throw cherry tomatoes.
Yeah, we used to say we had a train, we had a trestle when a train would come over, we'd get on top of it and wing cherry tomatoes at people in cars.
That well, what do you do crazy. Now?
This is great. I was sleeping, right? This is the one summer. My friend, this guy's an idiot. He wakes me up and he says, Case, there's a guy sunbathing down at the field. Let's get a bucket of water and throw it on him. So the guy woke me out of bed. It was pretty early. It was like 10 or 11. So I'm like, all right, you're nuts. I'll drive. You get out of the car and do it.
Right.
So this guy gets out. He gets a big bucket of water, and we drive down in his truck, and I'm driving. The guy's wearing a Walkman, so he has no idea what's going on. He's laying there. He's getting the sun. My friend gets out of the car, walks up to him, throws the whole bucket of water on him, and the guy doesn't know what hit him. He gets back in the car, and I drive away. It was great.
That's not the
best. You realize how much effort goes
into it? Yeah, but you know what? I got to admit, I did some dumb stuff. This guy we knew used to sleep naked when I worked up at the summer camp.
But at least it's somebody you know.
Yeah, this guy used to sleep naked, balls naked. All the kids would go in for lunch. We worked in the kitchen, and he would just go out. While we're supposed to be working, he'd go out on the deck, all right, right on the water, lay down on the dock, get completely naked with his legs spread, and just like fall asleep and sunbed. So we got pissed because we're all working. So we took Nair and we sprayed it all on his, you know, pubes while he was sleeping. And then half hour later, he wakes up. He sees all the white crap all over him. He freaks out. He jumps in the water. When he gets out, he was totally bald. He freaked. You don't even, because think about it. You don't know what happened to you.
We used to be over my
sleeping naked.
Yeah. It's his fault for being naked.
Right.
Yeah, but I think this guy they doused with the water is a total stranger.
Random.
Oh, yeah. But he was wearing a Walkman. He was like a foreign guy.
How about the woman who got that ranch dressing down her back?
Strange. Oh,
and she looked like your grandma.
No.
It was so sad.
You don't know.
I used to go over my...
That woman could have had a heart attack.
But I wonder if she went home and told her family. Did they laugh? Or did
they like, oh, my God, there's a condom.
Or trying to go find it.
And she don't know it's ranch dressing.
Right.
Yeah.
The biggest problem with the guys with the...
She's probably getting AIDS tests.
The guys with the paint.
Buddy, you don't have AIDS, but you're allergic to salad.
You know, those guys with the paint gun, the biggest thing, they're lucky they didn't get killed, because what would happen is, like, a guy would be riding on his bike, and he would just see a gun come out of a car and hear a sound, and the guy would jump off his bike.
Yeah, you get scared.
You think you're getting shot at.
Right.
You know, one time the cops told on us, right, and he filed this one kid back to his house. And he calls me up, and he says, look, there's a cop here, and he wants to talk to you. So I think he's joking.
Yeah.
The cop gets on the phone and says, well, what did you guys just do with the tomatoes? And I said, he said, what were you doing with the video camera? Because we used to videotape all this. And I said, actually, what we're doing is...
He's like those guys who rob, bodegas and videotape themselves, killing the guys in the bodegas.
So he says, what were you guys doing with the video camera and the cherry tomatoes? And I said, we're actually filming a documentary about two homosexual aliens that live out in the Hamptons, and it's a big gay love story, and it's great. Turns out it was a real cop, and he came over to my house.
Mm.
So when he came over, he's like, where's the tape? And I had destroyed it.
Mm.
And at the same time, I just date this girl, and she gets dropped off by her sister. We're still in high school, and there's a cop car in my driveway.
Mm. I don't know what he said.
No, we used to go over to my friend's house, Howard, when my friend's parents weren't home, and we'd order pizza to the house.
Pizza.
And then we'd go on the roof with eggs. And when the guy showed up to deliver pizza, we would egg the pizza guy.
Pitiful pizza delivery guy. You're not bad enough, you have to deliver pizza.
You'd egg the guy, but would he see you doing it?
We'd be on the roof of the house.
But he didn't see you, right? Then you just hide.
Yeah, we'd egg him and hide.
And then what did you do? Then he rang the bell and you answered the door?
No.
Yeah, we didn't even pay for the pizza.
We never paid for the pizza.
Animal.
Wow.
That's great. What you do is you get girls to talk to the front door, and you go around back and you steal the pieces out of his car. Yeah. Until the guy came back one time.
That's great.
You know what I'm sitting here thinking? You guys are the reason people put those razor blades in the apples on
the I know.
Now, Robin, he came back and he said, hey, I don't care that you ate the pizza, just give me the warmer back. It cost me $50.
The delivery guys get lazy and they don't lock the car. They jump out of the car.
Right. They're trying to be fair.
Yeah, never thought of that. So you guys would sneak into the car while the girls kept them busy?
Yeah,
girls
why would just talk to them like, hey, how you doing?
How many pizzas would you get out of there?
We'd just like take two pizzas or something like that. And, and we came back, who ate the pizza? We all had sauce on our face.
All bloated.
Yeah. We didn't do it, man.
Iggy, you're on the air.
Hey, you guys are freaking nuts, man. Well, I was in school back in the early 70s where some guy, we called him Filthy Nye. He stank like hell before gym class. And the only way this guy'd get a shower is after we were all done showering. We'd throw him in the shower and block the doorway. We wouldn't let him out until he was done scrubbing.
That's like a, what do they call
it?
I was afraid that would be me because I knew that the jocks would find out that I wasn't showering.
Right.
But for some reason.
I mean, this guy was really bad. We called his mother Pincushion.
Why is that?
She got stabbed so freaking often.
Really? You guys were very sensitive.
Jesus.
Wow.
Sounds like a great place.
Well, you know what the jocks used to do in my school? They used to put freshmen naked in like a big cardboard box and tape them up and then put them in the shower. And the only way the guy gets out is when the water finally gets, you know, gets all the cardboard, you know, mushy
wet,
they can break out.
And to be naked.
Yeah, but,
there's a lot of jocks do a lot of naked stuff.
They are very cruel and vicious jocks.
Tim, go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Me and my friends, about a couple months ago, we were driving down the road and we had a carload full of soup cans and we were throwing them in Mexican.
What?
He takes, dude. You shouldn't be. First of all, that's you could go to jail. That's racial.
Yeah, I know. We got in trouble for it, but
they're throwing soup cans.
They did get in trouble.
Throwing soup cans at Mexicans.
You could kill somebody with a soup can.
We used to do all kinds of stuff. We had like frozen oranges.
Meanwhile, probably the Mexican guys. The Mexican guys were like, "Wow, this is a great country. They feed you. They feed you right on the side of the road."
We also had a paintball gun too, and we had a few people. Like one lady, she was going to her mailbox to get something, and we fired it and exploded in her hair. She had like a fro.
Oh,
there's a lot of crazy hijinks. That's why you're walking down the street. You never know what's going to happen to you.
That's
you
why
know
kids can't trick or treat anymore.
Yeah, it's just it's bad.
You know what the big thing up by me? To fight back.
You know what the big thing up by me is? I see it. Everyone's got the mailboxes at the bottom of the driveway. You know, the old-fashioned mailboxes.
Yeah.
And you drive down and you see that somebody's clearly been by with a baseball bat.
Yeah, right.
You know, playing mailbox baseball.
Oh,
yeah, we used to play a game called Cholito the Guido.
Yeah.
You know, like Taco Bell used to have these things called Cholitos.
Right.
So we used to get some of them and throw them at, like, Italians, and they're like the IROC.
At Italians. Wow.
Cholito the Guido.
Throw them at an IROC.
Cholito the Guido.
Like, guys just walking around town and swinging at them. Guy like wearing a tank top. Cholito de Guido.
I don't even want to be.
Now, what age did you start tormenting your peers?
Cholito de Guido.
He's an angry guy. Casey's the angry jock.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hey, we're going to Cholito de Guido.
Oh, and the fire extinguishers. That was a good one,
what?
Too.
Yeah, everybody.
My friend took his fire extinguisher and stole one time. We go to drive through like McDonald's and stuff like that.
Yeah,
and when the poor woman would give us like a hamburger, someone would blast her in the face and she would get bucked back like five
feet. That's a standard one, Howard. That's a standard one.
The Burger King window after, chasing after a car. Like, what the hell is he going to do? And we're spraying him as he's chasing.
And they're all white.
Throw away.
That's so wrong.
That is so wrong. All of this is wrong.
First of all, you know, they're doing it to poor people who are just like, I hate being in this stupid Burger King outfit. I hate having to deliver pizza.
Oh,
and
man.
Egged
life is bad.
And by the way, like the Learning Channel, I'm presenting this so people know what to look out for. Yeah. Joe, go ahead. You're on the air.
We're kids, Robin.
Yeah, Howard.
Naive.
Yeah.
Naive.
Hello?
Yeah.
One of the funny things that I did was we had this really mean guy in our block when I was a kid. The guy used to throw water on the street, throw crap on the street so we couldn't play in front of his house. A couple years later, we went back. We hired a couple of Mexicans when the guy left for work to break up his whole front sidewalk.
Oh, no.
Yeah, like you hire them and say, hey, listen, I want
need
some...
need you to do some work.
I want some work on my house.
Exactly.
Oh, that's wrong.
Good.
All right, thank you. Well,
thanks.
Let me tell you, all this stuff is hijinks. It's all wrong.
I just remember this old lady be like, hey, outside of Pathmark, and they were about to square it. I say, hey, did you get any bargains today? And then it blasted with a fire extinguisher.
Listen to that.
He's so happy.
Only to be back in college.
Howard,
okay,
see. Howard, I tell me about
you learned
it.
So much.
You did.
This guy got 800 on his boards.
No, I didn't get
and you wonder why he was.
What'd you get, 840?
790.
Oh, you got 790?
No, 820.
820.
I got 790 PSAT, and I did better, and I got 820.
Howard, when you were like in 8th
class, too.
When you were like in 8th grade, did you?
Took a class, you got. Imagine. Probably went to like Stanley Kaplan. Well, what'd you get on your first SAT? 790.
And he's like, well, what do you think we're going to do for you?
Well, let's say we get you up 50 points.
You know what? I think it was the other way around. I think I got the high score on the PSAT, and I took the class at the Jewish Center, and I got a 790.
You got stupider.
Jews.
The Jewish.
You got stupider.
You get 600 for signing your name.
No, you know, you get 200.
On each test.
You probably figured Jews could make you smart.
Yeah, right.
The Jews must know something.
The Jew's head exploded. He couldn't believe it. He goes, I can't help this guy.
Howard, when you were in junior high school and you were walking down the hall, did anybody ever come and just knock your books out from behind you?
No.
That was Casey, though.
No.
You had to.
It wasn't.
I think they thought I was. I was just odd in my high school. People didn't pick on me,
were missed by everybody.
Yeah, and they just didn't pay attention to me.
Yeah.
See, we had a woman in my school that I still think about all the time. I really feel sorry for her. I wonder whatever happened to her. She made the mistake. She was not an attractive woman to start, and she made the mistake of saying she was a Buddhist and that she worshipped cows. And I remember people used to would just drive down the block and throw stuff at her and call her, and call her a cow lover. And he's like, there goes the cow. And she was one of those chicks that would just take it. You know, it was like, you know,
yeah,
don't worry.
Yeah, you could just heat
I could
it
take
on.
It.
Yeah. Well, what do you do? Yeah. High school, I was ignored.
But
I
that's
definitely
probably better, because otherwise you could have been.
I'm definitely peaking now.
The brunt of his shenanigans.
I know guys who peaked in high school.
Oh, I know
they
a lot of
the
them.
Coolest guys in high school, and now they're losers.
You're looking at one there.
I know a guy who
was KC. I peaked in college.
Yeah, college.
Somebody called a fake, bomb threat in my high school, and when they corralled all the kids out of school, one of the teachers had a heart attack and died.
Wow.
And it was a fake. Thing.
Yeah.
And I,
no, it was just
fake
like a
bomb.
Yeah, because in my high school, everyone always did the fake bomb scares to get out of school.
It was a fake thing.
Pizza.
I used to get on a
vodka and pizza.
Throw eggs at the. Hey Howard, I used to
pizza
have two
delivery guys.
Standard.
Okay, I used to have two dogs, and I used to have to clean up after them.
Yeah.
So I'd have to save all the dog turd. And he's garbage bags, right? So one day I get a great idea. I said, I'm not going to touch the dog crap, but I'm going to get gloves.
Right.
So I pick a little nugget and wing it at my brother when he came home from school.
He deserved it.
Throwing dog crap at him.
Nice.
That's funny.
Such joy.
It's great.
These are like the happy childhood memories I have.
Yeah. You know, there was always a guy in your neighborhood that was a little disturbed. The guy around the corner from me put out his pumpkin. And remember how kids would always steal pumpkins?
Yeah.
He used to spend all day. He would tap in straight pins
doing over
backwards.
There, by the way?
He would what?
Tap in straight pins backwards. You know,
right.
In
the pumpkin?
Yeah. Right. So it was like a big pin cushion except backwards.
Right.
And then he'd sit there and wait. All of a sudden you hear somebody stealing the pumpkin. Ah!
Oh, that's great.
That's great.
That's
like
funny.
That. Yeah, keep your hands off my pumpkin.
Yeah. I know one year my dad got pissed because kids were egging his house.
like in that movie?
Yeah.
Can't Fire Me Love?
Yeah, right. So, I don't know. He did something weird to some of those kids. I think I blocked it out. All I know is they stopped egging out.
What do you think
don't
he did?
Don't mess with my
home.
I
go back and dig
I don't
up
know,
that
man.
Jar.
He got him.
How did he know it was there? Oh, he saw him outside?
He raped him. No, I don't know. I don't know. Somehow they stopped.
Well, stop crying.
That's
not the house to do
stop
it.
Stop crying and bend over.
I used to sock houses. You ever do that on Halloween?
Yeah.
Fill up a
with
bag.
Flour?
Yeah, fill up a bag of chalk and socks.
Oh, yeah.
I was a little kid, though.
It's harmless. It washes away.
I don't know, but then
the
I got
soaping
lit.
Was the bad thing because it's
soaping what
to get
the house.
Yeah, the soap windows. In the house and the
egg in the house is the worst.
Egging was bad too.
Because it's the worst. It's over. You can't get egg off your house. That's no. real bad.
No, they used to egg it. The cars.
No, I saw them. They took a Volkswagen Beetle in my neighborhood. And, you know, there's a lot of shaving cream in those little cans.
Yeah.
And you used to get those little fly windows open, and you just kept squirting and squirting. And they would fill up the VW with shaving cream.
Oh, that's funny.
We came out to the bus one day. We saw that. We cried.
David, you're on the air.
Yeah, Howard, I used to be a players rep for the Dallas Cowboys, and they used to have a rookie night where they take out the rookies at training camp to this bar called Nail and Bash. They would get the rookie really drunk and sloppy to the point where they'd have a friend of theirs staged in the corner of the room, a big black guy, and they'd tell him, whatever you do, do not get so out of shape here that you pass out. That guy's known to take people. He's under investigation. Long story short is they'd get the guy so drunk where they'd actually knock him out. They'd bring him up to this hotel that's a block away. They'd strip him naked in bed, wipe Vaseline all over his ass, and put Red Hot, which is this heat cream, in their crack. They would not tell the rookie anything. So the next day in training camp, he would show up, and no one would say anything during the entire training camp.
That's a great one.
Yes, they wouldn't tell him until later.
Vaseline and Red Hot. And the last thing he remembers is there's a big black guy. They said, be careful, don't get too drunk. Yeah. He's about to rape the players.
And they wouldn't, no one would say anything until the end of training camp. So for 3 months, the guy's just in agony thinking that he got split.
Oh, that's great. Probably at the doctor getting checked. Yeah, that's a good one. Thanks.
I'll give you a great one, Adam. Yeah. Ratzel wrote a book about the New York Rangers.
Hmm.
And in the late 70s, what they would do to the rookies is they had this old rusty razor that they kept around just for the rookies. And it was old and rusty, hadn't been sharpened forever. And they would get the rookies naked. They would duct tape their feet together and their arms together, and then they would just shave their private areas.
Oh. Wow.
It was like really painful.
See, that ain't funny.
I know.
That's a little gay.
Yeah, that's gay.
You even know
that. Yeah, even Casey knows that. Yeah. What is it, Ganji?
Hey, Eric, can I tell you one? We used to have this.
Listen to Ganji's voice. What happened to you?
I went skiing, and I think from like skiing up in, you know, the snow and everything, I lost my voice.
From skiing, he got the voice.
Skiing is known to hurt your voice.
Yeah, people. Yeah, you know, I know a guy skied into a tree and died. It was Sonny Bono, but
it was cold and it was snowy, and I was out and skiing.
He skis on his voice.
Dude, it's probably because you didn't sleep and you eat all the wrong things. That's why your voice is all screwed up.
That could probably be it too. Let me tell you this story.
Could you step on those 2 feet right there?
How much do you weigh? I weigh a lot.
218?
Are you over 218?
Yeah, oh yeah.
230?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, come on.
No, I don't
think step on the scale.
Come on.
Let's see what you weigh.
These big shoes.
Let's see.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Oh, my. Get out of the way.
wait, stand still. 235. Oh. 236.
I have shoes on. I have big shoes on.
All right, take 5 pounds off.
Let me tell you this story. Get off my weight. So when
Let's get back to your voice.
When we were kids, we had this Indian family that lived next door to us.
Yes.
And we used to pickle stuff outside in these big jars.
They pickle stuff?
All the time. So we used to empty the jars out and then go number one in the jars.
Oh! Nice. Casey laughing.
And then we'd always
see, that's terrible.
We always had this one kid that hung out with us that we always hated, but we liked having him around because he was fun to goof on.
Right.
So
sort of like you with us.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly. So like we'd make him go out and buy us beer, and then we'd always take one beer out, empty it out, and then we'd go number one in it, and then close it back up, and then put it back in the case.
Oh my God. That's nice.
That's a big athlete.
Yo, I have one.
I hope they gave the pickled food to your mom. Oh, Mrs. Ganji.
Did I eat some of this?
Would like to give you some of my pickled food?
It's ready for your fat son.
Hey, Ganji, did you get any skiing?
No.
You skied?
Yeah, I snowboarded.
Where'd you go?
Mount Snow.
Oh, you're the fag who can't ski and you snowboard? And you
I can't ski. I just don't want it anymore.
And you got laid?
I'm snowboarding.
No, you didn't get laid. Either.
No, I didn't get laid.
What happened?
Another fruitless adventure.
I woke up with Vaseline and
I didn't go out.
But even the people on the trip, there's nobody you could bang on a trip?
No, no.
Who'd you go with?
Just like friends I grew up with, you know.
Guys?
Guys and a couple of their girlfriends.
Oh, all friends.
Oh, they had girlfriends.
Probably everybody else was having sex. Kenzie's watching.
It must suck planning a trip in advance for New Year's Eve knowing that there's no chance you're going to get laid.
Well, you know, we didn't go out. So, because it was snowing the whole time, so it's hard to go out of there.
You're single, though. Like, you know, what, you plan a trip that you can...
With this girl.
Yeah, I don't understand it.
It's something me and my friends have done every year for the last 10 years, and it's like kind of...
So you ever gotten laid for 10 years in a row?
No, I mean, there's times I have, you know.
The only reason you go skiing is to hang out afterwards, get drunk, and then score. I mean, that's
right.
The whole thing.
That's it. That's the party.
Ganji didn't learn that.
It was snowing the whole time.
Dude, even I know that. I'm just recently single.
You can't get laid when it's snowing outside?
No, because we didn't go out. We stayed in our house.
We. What about you? They had girls.
Dude, they had girls.
Ask a girl that you're friendly with. Hey, you want to go skiing with us? Come on up. Hang out.
Out.
I mean, you got to make some opportunities.
I didn't take anybody.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know,
dude,
how hard
you're
it is to get laid in the snow and can't do anything but drink all day.
I mean,
it's
right.
hard to get laid that
yeah,
way.
Yeah, right. You're out, you know, snowboarding, you're drinking. You don't want to get laid at night. You're too tired.
How do you not hit on the girls that are skiing? How do you not just go, hey, on the...
Yeah, there's nobody on the mountain.
Say, hey, you know, what are you doing today?
No, we went to a gay mountain.
They're strangers.
Yeah, we found a mountain with lots of guys.
So how long have you been on ski patrol?
I don't know.
I'm crazy.
It's called Mount Men.
So you operate the chairlift? You're very cute.
Dude, you didn't...
There's got to be somebody working there.
Why
something?
Is that sun so crazy?
There were no girls at the mountain?
No, there was, I'm sure, but I was skiing.
You skied right past
me. Yeah.
And dude, don't you lose any weight doing all that activity?
That's how I want to snowboard.
You're right. Big fat giant snowman.
He skis with a sandwich.
You want to know a great way to get laid at a ski mountain?
Yeah. How do you get laid at a ski mountain?
When you go up on a chairlift, right, generally you go up in pairs.
Right.
There's a singles line. You get behind a cute chick on the singles line. They go single or something, and then you just get on.
Right. You know what?
There's no desire.
I was snowboarding by myself, and I did that, but no one ever got on the chairlift.
But you
got
to
only guys got on the chairlift with me.
Kids, you got to look at the line and match it up.
They show you weigh 236. They say, we're not getting in with them.
Chair tilts.
I break.
The chair was hanging left.
Excuse me, girls. I'm a big, fat, horny, jolly jerk. Let's go. Let's have fun.
But can you stop on that snowboard once you start, or is it zip right down the hill?
That thing doesn't zip anywhere.
Times and get up and then
when
because
you were done,
you just stop on various parts of the slope just to talk to people.
How do you pick up chicks though when you sound like Joan Rivers?
Yeah, but then when you're done, right? Everybody's done for the day. Don't you go inside to the lodge with
get
the big giant
drink?
Bar?
Yeah, what goes on at the lodge?
No, we went back home.
But why would you do that?
Because it was snowing. It was like a blizzard, and we didn't want to get stuck.
At the lodge with all the girls.
In the bar with all the girls.
You don't want to get stuck at the bar with the girls.
Yeah, because at midnight you might actually have to kiss one of them.
And they
might take you home with them. Yeah.
What was that?
Me and Stein once went to the lodge, and in like 10 minutes we were like invited to a whole party with a bunch of chicks.
Right.
And it's so easy because everybody wants to party.
That's what you go there.
Not Gangie.
It's the Hamptons.
Gangie had to get home.
I want to go watch the Weather Channel in my room. I wasn't alone. I wasn't like
I need to get back.
I have to find out how much.
Dude, so you walk away from the group.
Make your own way.
We. You're not a we. You're alone.
Sure. I was with a group of people, and this is what we were doing.
What are the other guys? The other guys didn't want to get laid either?
Some were with their girlfriends. Some were, you know.
What about the single guys?
I don't think there was it. I think it was one. It was like one single.
It was all couples and you.
So you send them home. There was a couple single girls who I grew up with.
So don't they want to go? Don't they want to mess around with you?
No, no. The girls like no.
Keep them around for bait. You bring them to the bar.
Were you attracted to any of the girls?
No.
So what you say to them? Let's all go to the lodge. You'll be there with a group of chicks. You're talking.
It sounds like the girls look like Angie.
Yeah.
Rent a snowmobile.
All they wanted to do was sit in the house and drink.
In the house and not have sex.
Yeah. They don't have sex with me. They've known me 100 years.
Right. Even girls who get drunk and don't want to have sex with you for fun.
Yes.
That's the life story.
Sometimes girls just like, you know what? What the hell? Gangie's here.
I'm drunk and horny.
How do you know? You got to get them drunk.
I'll bet you, Howard.
I've been with them when they've been totally drunk and they're not like that.
I'll bet you.
You're not like that.
Exactly. I bet you've got a hold of one of those girls that they probably would say,
I need to talk to these girls.
If Gangie would make the littlest move, I might think about it.
Right, because he never asks.
No.
You are a douchebag. You're a douche.
They think you're gay.
I am not a douche. Why must...
You're a douche. You're wrapped up like a douche. A runner in the night.
I went skiing a bunch of
You're
friends.
A douche.
Why must I...
You're a douche. That's all there is to it. You're a douche.
You know, he doesn't realize
that I'm a
that
douche.
Guys ask over and over and over again the same girls.
Oh, that's how John got... Yeah.
If that's all there's there...
That's how John got married.
That's how John got his first girlfriend.
I know. You know what? Karen rejected you, 50,000 times?
Karen had the producer of the Channel 9 show pull me aside and tell me never to go near her again.
And you went out with her for how many years?
For 3 years.
Yeah.
He wore her down. That's what you
Yeah, he doesn't realize that guys ask a million times.
You know what your problem is? You take no for an answer.
What an idiot I am.
But when you're sitting there and with those girls and they're all drinking, and even though they're your friends, like, hey, what for the night? What the hell?
I've
kind of thrown it out, but they're all like, yeah, all right, get away from me.
You does the subject sex ever come
how
up
does
in
he throw it out?
Yeah. How do you throw it out? Tell me how you threw it out.
From across the room.
I'd be like, all right, let's say to my friend, I have my friend Janine. I'd be like,
all right, hey, listen, you're alone. You know, I'm alone. Why don't we go upstairs? So, why don't we hook up?
No.
Dude, have you ever crawled into bed with a girl? Just crawled into bed, like your friends, and you're like, oh, it's really cold. You might if I get in.
Yeah.
Let me massage your feet.
Hey, would you like the pink hot dog?
But you're not thinking.
Let me eat the marshmallows off your belly.
They don't think of you like that?
No.
No.
They don't know he has a penis.
I'm a snow bunny.
You know, you're a girl. I should stick something in you.
Let's hot pepper him.
Let's put Vaseline on him.
And the
red hot.
He's asexual.
Yeah.
Hey, it doesn't seem like friends are going to go for me.
Of course they don't see me because they're friends, but then all of a sudden you turn them into girlfriends.
Yeah, you can't even get a kiss off of them, I bet.
No, I can kiss them.
No, I'm a real kiss.
Oh, I'm sure if I just went up to them and said, kiss me, they'll kiss me, but just
no,
as a goof,
I'm at a real
like
kiss.
Well, they'll take it as a goof. Maybe they'll like it.
Start somewhere.
You got to start.
Kiss him.
Let's play spin the meatball.
Spin the what?
Spin the meatball.
Yeah, you tell me at least you do yourself, so I know that there's some drive in there.
Yeah. Oh, that's gross. I didn't even know that.
Oh, you did yourself at the ski lodge? At night?
No, I didn't.
I'm trying to make sure he's alive. Yeah. You know?
When was the last time that you got it, Kenj?
I told you. It's been a while. It's been like, I think like almost a year.
Were you old for 2000?
He's single and he works for the Stern Show.
Yeah.
What?
Did you get fellatio at least?
No.
I've hooked up a couple times, yes.
What does that mean?
No, he hasn't gotten fellatio, to answer the question.
He said he didn't get laid. Maybe he got.
No, he didn't.
Up there, no.
No.
Or anywhere.
No, anywhere.
This year?
No, yeah. Tell the truth. Yeah. That's a lie.
How much did it cost?
You got oral?
How much did it cost?
You didn't get oral. I got to take a break. I'm sickened by you.
God.
I don't understand why it's so hard.
Here's what I don't understand.
Why is it so hard?
You're at a ski resort.
Right.
You're single.
Right.
Okay, the girls you're with are your friends, whatever.
Right.
Take them, go drink at the ski lodge where the parties happen.
That's usually what we do. It was snowing the whole time we were
So it's a ski lodge.
No, no, we were staying.
So what's the worst that happens? You get snowed in with the girls.
A bunch of people you don't know and might
I need a lift. Come to my house.
Fun, fun, fun.
It's not staying like 20 minutes away up on a hill. No one wants to drive you that far.
Take a cab.
It's Vermont. There's no cabs
Yes, there is.
There's a way. Ask a girl for a ride home.
Exactly.
There are cabs there.
Take your stupid surfboard and surf home.
Go with them.
I'll paddle up the hill. Just give me something.
It doesn't seem like going away for a few days was like that hard not to.
Well, once you've already it's been a year.
Once you spent 364 of them alone, what's another day? Right, exactly.
I'm on a roll. What's
I'm having fun with myself.
Setting record.
I enjoy me.
I'm going steady with me.
No one else enjoys me. I enjoy me.
I'm having sex with the one I love.
You used to tell us how all the girls love him.
Oh, yeah. Get on mic. Get any girl.
Gage used to tell me and Robin, that all the girls love him. He could easily get women.
Hey, Gage, what happened to the girl from the e-party, the Christmas party?
Right, he didn't see her.
I don't know. Did you ever call her?
She was eliminated.
She's been away since then.
She won't call
Maybe
me.
Maybe she wanted to go skiing.
Exactly.
No, she's not good enough.
Yeah, she couldn't come to the lodge.
All right, we got to take a break. We'll be back right after these words.
This guy, KC, who works for me, I wonder about him.
Why? What do you wonder?
Well, he comes into me the other day, and he asked me a question. And in a serious way. He wasn't kidding. And he said, Howard, let me ask you something. If a horse is in a horse race and he wins, do you think the horse knows? Do you think he's happy?
And come on. He wasn't joking.
He wasn't kidding. As a matter of fact, you know he's not kidding because you were watching him talk. Tell me.
You don't think that the horse knows that he did a good job?
Of course not. It's a horse. The horse runs. You have to hit the horse to run. It doesn't know it's in a race.
And that doesn't hurt them, by the way.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying to you.
What about?
How do you? How about your dumb question?
Happy on a horse.
Why is it such a dumb question? What
you
know?
Think a horse knows a race is set up, he's in a race?
Do you think he knows when he's made it to the Belmont?
What you're asking me is, you think the horse knows he won a race?
Right.
Of course not.
How do you
he's
going
to get fed better?
Yeah, right.
How do I know?
Yeah, like the animals like.
Why didn't the horses set up racing themselves?
Right.
Come on.
How do you think a horse knows?
It's not that silly of a question if you think about it.
All right.
What you're saying is that you're making a decision that you know what the horse is thinking. How do we know what they're thinking? You don't think that they have some kind of pride when they win?
You think one horse looks at the other like, I'm going to beat your ass, man?
No, I don't know about that, but I'm thinking they might have some sort of pride when they win.
You hired this guy?
I'm so destroyed with myself.
How do you know?
I really thought he was smart.
I want to get the race over.
I want to know why I'm such a bad judge of character.
No, you're not using your imagination.
He had somebody else write the stuff he said.
Casey, when the race is over, how does a horse know he won? How does he know he just...
What they do is they give him...
He doesn't even know what a race is. It's a horse.
How do you know?
Because they don't know what a race... A race is a concept that mankind has set up. Horse doesn't know there's a race going on.
That's what you think. You don't know.
The horse. The horse doesn't know to run.
You're insane.
You know, the winner gets a wreath put around his neck. For all the horse knows, they're hanging him.
No. You
say, they have no idea.
But if the horse knew anything about the race...
Dogs are happier dogs.
Wouldn't it run faster than the other horses just because?
Dogs,
why would it have to be prompted?
Dogs are happier dogs when they do work rather than sit around.
That's true.
Right?
The dog is not necessarily happy. The dog, it's its nature to go out and run around.
Right.
Not to win a race.
But you don't know.
But
you don't know
that.
They
have dog races too. You think they know when they win?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, they probably do because they get fed better.
No, they don't.
Yeah. So
it doesn't matter. A dog gets fed has nothing, no relation to anything else.
All right. I tell my dog to sit. The reason why
you know a horse could beat you on an IQ test.
The dog sits because I gave it food to teach it that way.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So now, if the horse wins the race, it's probably treated better than when it loses. And now it wants to win.
Oh, my God.
The understanding that there is a race going on, that there's a competition, is such a human thing. Horse doesn't know it's in a competition.
Yeah, but that's what you think. You have no idea. You have nothing to back it up. That's just your opinion.
Oh,
Casey, with your eyes, do you understand the competition?
Do you know what you're talking about?
Yep. You're saying that you know what a horse is thinking, and I don't think you know.
No, you're saying you know as well, though.
Well, I'm saying maybe. I'm saying, do you think? I asked the question. I said, do you think? You never think about that stuff?
Have you ever seen horses racing without people around?
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah.
No, you've seen horses running.
They're running. They're running
for a reason. You've never seen them racing.
But, you know, they might be racing with their friends. Who knows? You think this is silly, but it is silly, but just use your imagination.
I've seen two horses in the field. I've seen them prancing around. I've seen them knocking around.
You know what, this is crazy.
Never seen them get in a straight line.
So I start getting into this. I start getting into this logic with him. And it makes me insane because I'll tell you why it makes me insane.
I know what you're gonna say.
That I hired him.
You're gonna say, why can't he spend his time thinking of things that are for the good of the show?
Right.
No, rather not than for horses. Logic. Don't think of anything.
I can't help it.
Broken brain.
I can't.
Do you think cows get upset because they know they're going to be eaten?
Oh,
let me get the answer.
You know, you don't know.
I do know.
You don't know. Cow has no awareness. A cow just sits and has no feeling whatsoever.
No, it doesn't have feelings. It doesn't know it's going to be eaten. What?
You don't know.
You think
that.
The cow understands that it's going to be slaughtered?
Where's all of his friends going?
Oh,
you
come
think
on.
They try to escape?
If a cow goes to the county fair and he wins the steer competition, they throw a blue ribbon on him. Is he happy?
Well, he's done it once, so he probably doesn't know. But if you do it a bunch of times,
and does he? So what if he wins? That's a bad thing.
I know it's silly. I know it sounds silly.
What if he starts at the counties and goes to the states? Does that make him happy?
I don't know what they're thinking. And I just posed the question.
But the horses, he knows.
I just posed the question. That's
what
all.
About the horses?
That why pose that question? It's not. It's a question that's completely retarded.
No,
a horse doesn't know it won a race.
I wish someone would back
me. A horse doesn't know anything.
So conversely,
a horse doesn't. Let me say, when a horse in Central Park is pulling a carriage, you think he knows what he's doing?
Or do you think he thinks if I could get out of here and run, I'd be much better off because then they treat me better?
Yeah, if I race, maybe I'd do better.
So you
do you think a horse is aware that he's pulling a carriage?
Yeah. You don't think so?
No.
So why is it heavier? Why is he?
It doesn't know anything. He just walks. That's what a horse does.
It's aware. You're saying he doesn't have any clue that he's carrying 100 pounds behind him.
No.
So does a horse know when he's being ridden and when he's not ridden?
No. He doesn't know what the concept of being ridden. There's just something. He just moves. There's no thought.
So why when someone comes up on top of a horse that's been ridden,
Howard is going
it's gonna
too
go
far
nuts.
Beyond. Yeah. No. The horse does know when something's on its back.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, but
and
it doesn't
he knows it's unnatural. That's why he tried to buck you off.
It's just something. It's like a fly. It's no difference between a person or a fly.
Not to a horse.
Okay, sorry. Get out of here. Get out.
All right, I'm just thinking. You should think about these things.
All right.
Hey, Howard. Oddly enough, I was sitting home yesterday having a bizarre thought as well. I want to ask Robin a question.
Yeah.
I was watching the basketball game. I don't know why this popped into my head, but
But I was looking at Larry Bird, and I was thinking, he's really getting funny looking.
He's heinous.
So I'm thinking, Robin, Desert Island, you, Larry Bird, and Jeff Van Gundy. Who wins?
Jeff Van Gundy or Larry Bird?
I think that's easy.
Yeah, it's got to be Larry Bird.
Larry Bird.
I don't know. I was looking at him yesterday. And
Larry Bird actually.
Not that funny.
Larry Bird actually looks like a bird.
He does. He has a bird-like face.
Yeah.
He's got the Adam's apple and like the long beak and stuff.
Yeah, he's a bird. He's turned into his name. A lot of people that happens to.
Little
hair. Can you rate Jeff Van Gundy looks 1 to 10?
2.
Jeff Van Gundy doesn't have any looks.
What is that? Hair plugs?
How can you see his face? He's so busy staring at those plugs.
And he's got the dark circles and he's always scowling and he doesn't look like a happy.
All right, let me ask you a question.
Friendly guy.
Be honest now and think about it. Don't just put out an answer. Gary Delabate or Larry Bird?
That's a tough one.
Wow.
She's got to go with Bird because
Gary Delabate or Larry
Here's
Bird.
Here's my uncomfortable laugh.
I'm going with Larry Bird.
All right, there you go. So, as funny looking as Larry Bird is to you, Robin saying she'd still do Larry Bird.
Right. Here's the one. Here, put the stake through my heart, Robin. Gary Delabate or Jeff Van Gundy?
You have to think about
the
it. That's even bad enough.
It's already insulting.
Right.
Jeff Van Gundy or Gary Delabate? I guess I'm going with Gary.
Yeah, I have all my hair, and I'll probably give it to you good.
Let me see them. Patrick Ewing or Gary Delabate?
Look at that. Discussing.
Let me think. Patrick Ewing or Gary?
I think you're going with Patrick Ewing.
I'm going with Patrick.
Wow.
Why?
Oh, my God. Because he's got a body.
Size?
Well, he's an athlete. He's got a body.
Yeah, he's an athlete. There's nothing going on upstairs at all.
What's that got to do with anything?
I'm insulted.
Wow.
I understand Larry Bird. I do not understand Patrick Ewing. Because I've heard you talk about him off the air, about how ugly you think he is.
But he's got something. He's got that body.
He's got it going on.
He's got a little something. I got a little nothing.
Right.
I'm glad I brought that up.
Gary Delabate or feces. So wait a second. So Patrick Ewing beat you out.
Yes.
Larry Bird.
Jeff
Van Gundy didn't.
There's something.
How about Cabby?
Oh.
Cabby or Gary Delabate?
She'll go with Cabby.
I would go with Cabby.
You go with Cabby. Oh, yeah, I believe that.
And what's the basis of that?
He's fun. He's, you know, he's like got something going on.
I'm fun. I got something going on.
I'm fun.
You get a laugh out of that.
Maybe looks like he knows his way around a woman.
Well, Gary has been with a lot of women.
Doesn't mean anything.
And yeah, once he throws your legs up in the air and you get a good look at his tattoos, that's got to be hot.
Tattoos give him a look.
Think about the tattoos. No,
it's a good look for him.
Gives him a look. It works. Nothing like a guy covered in writing.
Bad writing.
Yeah. Bad art.
You know, when you get that many tattoos, you know what it says to me?
What?
I give up. I know, like even like when Axel did it, it's like, why do you have to cover every single part of your body?
Right. The walking peacock. I like this Gary Delabate or...
Or whoever. Right. Any other mashups you want to throw at me?
No, I don't think so. I'm getting nauseous.
Trey or Gary Delabate?
I think Gary would win.
Oh.
Who's Trey?
The little guy who was just in your back.
Hey, if a horse wins a race, you think it's happy?
Oh, man.
Brr. What?
Hey, let me just close with one more thing here.
Oh.
So, listen, so I got a dog, right?
Yeah.
And the dog, I think, likes me.
I play Scrabble with him.
So the dog...
He wins.
Beat me.
He's getting pissed, man.
No, I'm not pissed, but the dog likes me, I think. So
the dog likes everyone.
No. And it counts on me to feed it and stuff like that, right?
Don't you want to bet I come into your house? The dog will be just as friendly to me.
No.
Of course.
No. See, it likes me because I feed it, right?
Okay.
So if something happens to me, you don't think a dog's going to be upset? That's a human emotion.
No, it's going to be upset if it doesn't eat.
No, because of me. Because I'm not around.
No. Wait a minute. There was a woman on Dateline last night who said that she, you know, she saves these animals in Africa.
Yeah. The animals don't know.
She had a baby elephant, and she nursed it back. Nobody even knew how to keep a three-month-old elephant alive.
Mm-hmm.
And she figured out the right formula, and she starts feeding the elephant. The elephant is thriving. And then she goes to her daughter's wedding somewhere in Europe
and trample her to death.
For 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And the elephant died of loneliness for her.
No.
And she discovered that she needed to have a whole, you know, she couldn't have the elephant attached just to her. She had to have a bunch of people so that he wouldn't die if she disappeared.
Robin, explain this to me. Why do animals often attack their trainers?
No.
I have no idea.
Here's the thing.
I'm
in Robin's case,
with this elephant.
In the case of Robin or the Casey's dog, animals do bond, like in packs. That's how they live. And in a surrogate, you become the surrogate. Why does a dog bond to a human? It does because it's a pack animal. Even elephants travel in packs, so they are pack animals.
Say the animal was just attracted to her. She said she knew if she put a bunch of people around it, then it would be okay.
You know why? Because the elephant associated feeding the smell of this woman as like a mother.
Right.
Not that it loved her. There was no love. The eating ritual was this woman, her smell,
the whole pack mentality.
Right.
They need to have interaction with other things.
Right. Your dog looks at you, though, and it don't feel anything.
Yeah, it does.
You're the only thing it has.
You're projecting onto it.
There was another.
Get out of here. I want to do the news and go home.
You think the dog's going to die when you die?
No. I'm just saying. There were studies shown when people left work.
The
dog ran to the window.
Right.
And
of course.
They know things. I'm telling you, they got like this.
Yeah, they know things. First of all, look. Here's what they talk
about.
They know
it's dinner time.
The dog knows. It can hear. And dogs have exceptional hearing. And in many studies, they see that a dog, if a guy drives his car, even before it turns the block, the dog knows he's coming.
Right.
Because the dog hears the sound of that car every day.
And he knows that you're coming home.
No, he doesn't know you're coming home. He knows the sound of a car. He knows
your
smell.
Your car.
Yeah, but it's not love, stupid.
Every car that comes by the door goes to the window.
No,
it doesn't. It knows your car because the hearing on a dog, they break down the sound of a car into 50 million more sounds than we do. So they can hear specific things within the sound of your car. It's not because they love you. They hear that sound every day, and they associate that with you coming in the door and feeding it.
If they can have that intricate of a system to...
First of all, he asked me, does a horse know it won a race?
That's a problem.
It doesn't know. Look, I want to do the news. Please, Robin. Please, I'm begging you. I got to get out of here.
It would tell me that, you know, the elevator would go up and down in the building all day long.
Good.
But when I was coming up in the elevator, the cats would run to the front door.
That's because you emit a low-pitched sound. The cats would hear.
Right. Passing wind.
You're just pissed off because animals don't like you.
Animals love me.
No, my dog
loves me. You don't know anything about me.
So you're saying that if you don't show up anymore, that dog's not going to be sad.
You don't know anything about anything.
You sound like someone who doesn't.
I know more than you about everything.
I have a question for you. Sometimes you go to the house on Long Island, correct?
Do me a favor. Throw a saddle on KC and ride him in a race.
Sometimes you go out to the house on Long Island, correct?
Right.
And Java is there.
Yes.
When Java sees you,
yes.
Is there a big reaction?
Yes.
Like a homecoming?
Yes. The same reaction gets to 50 other people. My dog loves people.
So it's not just you.
The dog knows me. Like, you could say to the dog, go to daddy. And the dog actually comes to me. You know why? Because the dog has the intelligence of a 3-year-old and understands about 400 words. Associates the word daddy with me. Not in love with me.
You don't think that dog likes you at all?
Yeah, our
the
food's
dog. The dog is a pack animal. It's instinct. It's bred in him.
See, Casey thinks he's got Snoopy. He thinks his dog likes to work. The dog's writing novels and flying planes.
Yeah. And missing Casey and sad. Get out of here now. Please, you disgust me.
All right,
you sicken me. You sicken me.
Arf, what are we going to watch on TV tonight, Casey?
Want to watch the Knicks? Hey, you're a gay dog. What do you think of Dan Marino's ass? Yeah, I think it's big, too.
That just amazing.
Unbelievable.
All right, on to another subject.
Right.
You think you're a Western horse?
Uh-oh.
Oh, I didn't really mean that. Oh, Lord. Oh, shit. Okay, boy.
Okay, boy.
I don't think he knows he's in a show.
Thank God you don't think that. I'm not sure she doesn't.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Yeah, I don't know.
Embarrassing.
You are hysterical.
I'm embarrassing.
You don't talk to your dog.
Oh, like an idiot. I just don't tape it. I go, this is how I talk to my dog.
You good girl. Yeah, come here, you good girl. Who loves you, your daddy?
He's not trying to win a blue ribbon, dude. Yeah.
It's just like that, but yeah,
I just don't.
That?
I just don't tape it.
That's right. Yep, yep. Come on, come on. There we go. Good boy. Good boy.
Mr. S.
He didn't talk back.
Hello, Robin.
He did not talk back, but take it easy. Come on, boy. Okay.
Where is that horse? Meanwhile, it's in the horse factory getting eaten.
Oh, no, my horse lives in New Jersey. He just moved to New Jersey.
He did? Yes. How's he like it?
He likes it just fine.
Just famous. Is he going to college?
Does he know?
Thinks his
face. You know, he likes that as well as the last place he left.
You think he knows he's in Jersey?
You know, he hates probably the really upset.
Let's ask Casey. Does he know he moved?
Did your toilet know when you're taking a...
Play? You think your toilet likes you?
You think you're a porcelain toilet?
You think your toilet knows between pee and duty?
My toilet smiles at me.
Oh, wouldn't you like to spend a day inside of his head?
Does your toilet completely empty? When you go on vacation?
You realize his thoughts are like a third of what we think?
You get sick of the echo in there. That was a good one, huh?
Not tested.
I wonder if a horse knows it won a race.
I think the horse is happy.
Give me hoof.
I'm going to ask my girlfriend.
Slap me some hoof. I want
that. That asswipe, Casey, comes in. And like right before I'm about to get back on mic, he asked me for $320 to pay for my lunches and stuff.
Uh-huh.
But his timing's... I mean,
he does that all the time.
He just... How about at the beginning of the...
Craig, it's no big worry.
Yeah, but dude, ask me at the... I take care of whatever you guys tell me to take care of.
But you can see I'm vulnerable. To get to you, though. That's the whole thing.
So do it at the beginning of a commercial or ask me for it directly after the show.
Yeah, but you don't like when I ask you after the show because you want to leave.
But if you can't seem to time it at the beginning of a commercial break, then don't do it.
Then you can actually do it.
What do I owe you?
$310.
All right, hold on. $200. $250. $300. Now, what do I got? $320? Yeah, you are a son of a bitch.
K-Rock.
$200.
K-Rock.
$250. No. $250. $300.
It's going right to the track.
What do you need? $320 or $310? $310. Pain in the ass, man. I'm on the air. Stupid ass. Here. Take that.
I think this is how he saves for the rent.
He's going to Belmont with it.
He's so dumb. He's cutting a commercial back there for Scott.
Uh-huh.
And it's for the lobster commercial. That
Lobstergram.
So they say you can get succulent lobster or filet mignon.
What
so,
is he saying?
So this idiot goes to Scott, how do you say that mignon? So Scott says, oh, it's that you're pronouncing it right, mignon.
Did he record it?
Yeah.
Oh, let me hear this.
Then dad, an impressive gift certificate that will allow him to choose between succulent live Maine lobsters, exotic lobster tails from around the world, or how about tenderly aged filet mignon? Dick. You're an asshole. You don't say... How do you say it? Mignon? Filet mignon. That's how you say it, you
Moulin
You're a douche.
He's a douche, man.
You want to fuck up that commercial? Mignon. How do you say that? Mignon. Filet mignon. That's it.
Are you idiot?
What college did you go to?
WKU, Western Kentucky, baby.
He got a 710 on his SATs combined.
Come on.
Listen to Scott all happy. Cheating.
You're a himbo.
But, hey, how often?
You know,
Western Kentucky.
You're cute.
Come here, you.
You're so lucky you're good looking.
We're going to get some filet mignon. I knew it was wrong when I said it.
You know what kills me? I fell for your good looks and hired you.
Come on, man. You don't think I do a good job for you?
It's all right.
Casey does a great job, man. Come on. Thank
He's not working for you, Artie.
My girlfriend loves this guy.
Nice.
Yeah, because he's good looking. But did you ever talk to him?
No, she don't care. She's going out with me.
No, you're a smart guy. He goes,
yeah,
you know
she
what?
Wants to have a conversation. She can talk to Nick.
Casey's on the phone today. We were listening, and he goes, yeah, I'm going to make dinner. I serenaded the meat. So we're like, serenaded the meat? What is he trying to say? We realize he was saying marinated, but he thinks it's called serenaded.
Singing to a pork chop.
Serenaded the meat.
You know, when you spotlight, yeah, it looks stupid. But what? If throughout the day, you make a lot of mistakes. Everybody does.
No, they don't. Not those mistakes.
Not the kind you make.
Not a 20. How old are you now?
I'm 26.
And you don't know serenade the meat.
Well, now I do. I mean, it was an honest mistake. It was just, you know.
You sing to your meat, which
but
you probably do.
How often have you eaten filet mignon?
Not very often.
Oh.
So how am I supposed to know?
That's a word you hear a lot.
No, you don't.
You never heard filet mignon?
Yeah, I've heard it before.
Yeah, listen to this.
Hey, Casey, real quick.
Yeah.
You were talking this morning to somebody. I overheard you.
Yeah.
You're talking about you were cooking some meat. And what do you do when you, and Robin, don't say anything. When you soak the meat overnight, what is that process called? What do you do to the meat?
That's the serenade.
You serenade the meat, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So how long did you serenade the meat?
For like three or 4 days.
You serenaded the meat for 3 or 4 days.
Yeah.
What were you cooking?
I cooked the George Foreman grill.
Did you see,
chickens.
So you can cook the chicken without any serenade on it.
Right. No, you leave it in there.
So you serenade the meat for 3 days.
Right.
Wait a minute, he left it in the grill for 3 days?
No, he serenades for 3 days.
But where does he serenade it?
In the freezer, and then you take it out and you put it in the refrigerator.
Okay.
You take the meat out, and what do you use as a serenade?
Either like teriyaki or you got like honey mustard. Not honey mustard. You got a hot sauce, you can put it in there.
So you serenaded the meat in hot sauce?
Yeah.
For 3 or 4 days?
For 3 or 4 days.
Yeah, what's wrong with
you? Believe what an idiot he is?
It was very difficult for me not to laugh.
Do you know why you're an idiot?
I held it in.
This is what I'm dealing with. This is my staff. Do you know why? Do you know why you're an idiot?
I'm sure you're going to tell me.
It's not called serenade. Serenade is when you sing to someone. It's called marinade.
So what? Same thing. Serenade.
So,
marinate the meat.
That's just how you pronounce it.
All right, get out.
Oh,
you should
come
be...
on. They're two different words.
What'd you get on your...
Little did I know that he serenades his mignon. How'd I know that?
What do you serenade the mignon in?
I love the way you just draw out my idiot remarks. I mean, it took like 3 minutes. I made a mistake. You took it into 3 minutes, like baiting me.
Thanks.
But you know what's really stupid about you, Casey? You defend your stupidity.
Well, Rob, what am I going to do? I'm going to, you know, I admit I was wrong.
Pronounce this. You've probably seen this word written down. H-O-R-S. D-O-U-E-R-V-E-S.
I got to write it down.
Write it down for him. Write down that word for him.
Oh, I know what that is. That's hors d'oeuvres.
All right.
Yeah.
Good.
There
on.
You go.
Yeah.
I know
what
that.
Else you got?
I know that.
That was it.
Yeah, see?
I make non-trivia.
But if you wrote it down, he wouldn't be able to...
hors d'oeuvres.
He'd have trouble with it if it was
hors d'oeuvres. Ay, ay, ay. You love not to know.
Well, hey, do you hear me say that again after I said it? Now I don't say it anymore.
You love not to know. You want to hide something from KC? Put in a book. Because he loves not to know.
Oh, boy.
Books are his kryptonite.
My kryptonite.
Books are your kryptonite.
Books are my kryptonite.
All right, I'm done.
Yeah, you sure are. Mignon. We should just call him Mignon from
How do you
now
say
on.
That?
His nickname is Mignon, and the other guy's Baba Booey.
Mignon.
Serenade Mignon.
Hey, Serenade Mignon, come in here.
That sounds
He's
French.
He's got two
nice.
Names, Serenade Mignon.
How about Mignon Cementhead? Anthony, you're on the air. Oh, sorry, Anthony, you're not on the air. Go ahead, Anthony.
Yeah, Howard, how you doing? Listen, talking about KC over there, huh?
Yeah.
I got his AOL profile up on my computer screen. Can I read it to you?
Yeah.
Okay, it says member name, KC, quote, two fingers in the air, two in my underwear. Underwear is spelled UNDERWHERE.
Oh.
Armstrong.
He's trying to be funny, but...
H-E-R-E.
Here we come. Dude, you spelled underwear wrong.
Underwear. UNDERWHERE.
All right. How do you spell
All right.
underwear?
Look, this is... the profile is just something I was in college. It's like 5 years ago.
Listen,
oh, in college,
so
and you're
now
proud.
Now he knows how to spell underwear.
Howard, listen.
Well, wait. Don't tell us... Tell us what words he misspelled, and let's ask him to spell them here on the air.
Oh, okay. He spelled judging wrong.
All right. How do you spell judging?
I need a piece of paper.
Come on. Judging, dude.
I do better when I, like, write it down.
I don't care what you do.
You wrote right. this.
J-U-D-G-E. No, there's no E in it. J-U-D-G-E-I-N-G. Judging.
It was close.
That's how he spelled it in the profile.
Unbelievable.
Still spelling it the same way 5 years later.
I got it, you know. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not a good speller.
You don't have to lie.
We're trying to figure out what you're good at.
I'm not going to lie to you. Chet, that you're lying to me.
Spell underwear.
Okay, we didn't give him the right spelling.
We didn't.
So probably what I did was in the last, you know, where, you could spell it W-H-E-R-E or W-A-R-E.
So which way do you spell it? Spell it now.
I'm trying to envision the package.
Spell the whole word.
U-N-D-E-R-W-A-R-E?
Okay. So you're retarded.
He's trying to envision
It's not like I don't know how to
package.
Spell it. I don't know why...
Oh, you were looking at a package? Maybe you should look at a woman instead of a package.
Howard, maybe this is the...
Underwear. W-E-A-R.
Oh, all right. Yeah.
Howard.
That's easy.
But I'm not going to lie to you. You're not a good speller.
Just ask KC if he knows what an ellipsis is.
A what?
An ellipsis.
What's an ellipsis?
Get that.
Ellipsis?
You don't know an ellipsis,
like elliptical will go around. So ellipsis.
What's the sentence he's got?
Okay. Make the sacrifice, comma, mutilate my faith. And then he's got two dots, and then he's got the rest of the phrase.
That's the Blue Mask. That's a Lou Reed song. It's a great song.
No, we're talking about the dots.
All right, listen.
What does that have to do with anything?
It's an ellipsis, douchebag. You don't know what an ellipsis is?
And what are you doing? Looking at people's profiles. What do you got to do in your life?
Well, I just...
That's an excellent point.
Stuck out at me.
What?
This jumped out at me. I mean, look what it says. Marital
what are you doing? You got to go search my profile, you homo?
Marital status. Awaiting death, it says.
Yeah.
Howard, you want to hear his hobbies?
Yeah.
Okay, licking stamps, judging nude robot dancing contests.
Yeah.
And
so
watching
funny.
Bananas get spots on them.
Right.
Funny.
I started Y2K and I like pudding. Occupation, full-time sleeper, part-time death expert. Personal quote, make the sacrifice, mutilate my face. If you need someone to kill, I'm a man without a will.
That's Lou right there.
How old are you, Casey?
I told you I was in college.
All right, it's enough. It's making me sick. I'm losing more and more respect for myself. As I listen to this.
Because you read that profile and hired him.
Yeah. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm no athlete.
Yeah. Hey, Howard. Yeah. I was also the one I called John earlier about that douchebag Chauncey. And I can't believe that guy has no idea how to use hyphens, how to use commas.
I know. He's supposedly
he's a
journalist. All right, thank
Every
you.
Every other word is misspelled.
What is this guy, a professor?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, you
he
know
knows
what,
how to spell. He's an
I'm
underwear professor. He knows how to spell underwear.
He's a journalist looking at people's profiles.
Well, I'm unemployed, man. I can't.
Oh, yeah, no wonder.
All kinds of money with that.
What a surprise.
All right. You'd be unemployed, too, if it wasn't for me.
I know. That's why I love you, bro.
Thank you. Tonight on TV, NBA basketball playoff final game.
Yes.
New Jersey Nets at Los Angeles Lakers.
It's
all right.
Time.
9-1, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
9-1.
The Nets are 9-1.
That's what it is. Bet.
It's not bad.
What are you
going to
do tonight, Arnie? Mm-hmm.
I don't know. That's an interesting decision.
Well, maybe you'll watch Channel 13.
Yeah.
But I do have some Shaquille O'Neal talking about, you know, what the Lakers need to do. And
they don't need to do much.
They say they... oh, God.
Is that you?
It's, no.
That's Casey's friends.
Right.
Is it, huh?
It's
funny.
Casey
Here's
singing.
Casey singing.
Put on your dancing shoes and tell us how you do.
Hilarious. He's serenading. I'm marinating.
He's marinating. Yeah. It's the Western Kentucky chorus.
The cool song.
Yes.
Gather your filet mignon.
Yo, Jeff. Go ahead, man.
Man, you guys were pretty gay the other night.
Pretty gay? How about very
totally.
Gay? But totally gay.
Gay.
I mean, pretty gay.
Gay square.
You're like faggots.
Well, you look like the madam at a gay whorehouse.
What'd you say?
Howard looks like the madam at a gay whorehouse.
Who looks like a madam?
You look like the madam.
You need to keep everything going, you know?
Why can't I hear this guy?
He doesn't hear us either. He keeps talking whenever.
I don't understand. I hear other shows. The host talks and then the people talk.
You can't hear me?
Now I can hear you.
Okay, it's supposed to be this damn.
All right, what do I look like, a madam in a gay whorehouse?
Yeah, sort of. I mean, you kept everything going, you know.
Well, yeah, that's my job.
Oh, I knew that, but Jackie now.
Jackie.
Jackie had no excuse for his antics.
Jackie was...
Oh,
Jerry.
I was ringleader.
All right, dude.
Shame to say it was fun.
I tell Me too. You, if Jackie had been drinking,
oh, could have been good.
Would have been all over.
Yeah, you know, something happened.
Michelle, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard. Hi, Robin.
Hi.
Fabulous show on Saturday night.
Thank you.
Gary, you are hot.
Gary?
Hey, Gary.
Gary stole the show. No question about it. When his hands came flying up in the air, I tell you, I almost fell off the couch.
How about when Baba Booey's head was resting on some guy's shoulder?
Oh, man, I dropped my drink.
Baba Booey.
Honest to God.
Who was he dancing with?
I don't know. I can't remember. I think one of the fags.
The real fags.
I think one of the real fags. But, Howard, I have a question. How come Ralph the fag wasn't there?
It's a good question. I don't know.
I completely forgot about Ralph in the planning.
Ralph said he would have been there, but...
Yeah,
come on. I think Ralph ducked out.
No, I don't know.
Usually he calls when he wants to get involved, and
right.
He didn't call.
I don't know what happened with that. It just was kind of thrown together quick, and we didn't really put that much thought into it.
And you know what else? Once or twice, you only, we forgot.
Well, you only aired one of the songs. Are you going to air the other song as well?
Yeah, I would have done both songs, but there was some discussion about that. And
yeah, it could have been weaved into the show.
I don't know. Jim was saying, well, gee, you know, you see one song, and then it's just a bunch of gay guys dancing. I go, well, that's kind of the funny part of it, I think.
I liked it.
I don't get tired of that, but we made a decision together that we wanted to get some of the backstage stuff in, too.
Yeah.
Well, and another thing, Fred, you have a huge unit, man.
Yeah, he's pretty well hung.
He won the contest.
Oh, did he? I thought Howard was the biggest.
No, Fred was bigger than me.
Oh, man, what a unit.
Hey, way to go, Fred.
Thanks.
Anyway, have a great show today, and thanks for Saturday.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Yeah, I watched the show. I enjoyed it, too. Jennifer, you're on the air.
Hi, Howard. Hi, Robin.
Good morning.
I loved your show on Saturday.
Thank you.
It was so funny.
Thanks.
How old are you?
I'm 26.
Oh, you sound very young.
Thank you.
Sounds like a young girl.
Yeah, I thought a 13-year-old was calling.
All right.
Young boy.
Howard, I'm so glad that you are so secure in your homosexuality to dance with that bald-head guy.
No, I'm so secure in my sexuality that I can dance with a...
Right. I didn't get it right.
How about Elephant Boy when he says, I'm 100% woman?
Oh. I think
good.
He is a woman.
Yeah.
I just wanted to say that Casey is very hot.
Isn't he?
All the gay guys wanted him.
Well, everybody wants him.
And Casey,
I want him too.
Was so scared.
Oh, please. That was a ruse.
Oh, come on. You think so? He was the most uncomfortable.
Oh, believe me.
No.
He was so happy to show his workout. The guy works out 24 hours a day.
I know. And today he's walking around with this little curl in the middle of his forehead, and I'm like, ugh.
Is it possible?
That's, what do you mean, no?
You know, it's just like, you know, it's like you with a girl. Why can't I have that?
You could have that. He'll do you.
No.
Sure he would.
Yeah, be personal.
Why are you being uptight?
If
you want that, I'll get that for you. Just tell me. How am I supposed to read your mind?
Oh,
Casey,
God.
Do Robin today.
Is Casey single?
Yes.
Is there any way I could ask him on a date for dinner?
Sure. Casey, come on in here. Girl wants to go to dinner with you. Are you hot?
He's very picky.
Yes.
Will you take him to a nice place?
Yes, I will.
What are you, a Puerto Rican girl?
I'm Dominican and Puerto Rican.
You're dark skinned?
I'm very light.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very funny. Like, all of her relatives blew away. She's
right.
Dominican.
Thanks, Robin.
Both hit by the hurricane.
What happened to Casey? He's not around?
He was here.
He's gay.
Mm.
He's bench pressing.
Thanks, Robin. Not all my family flooded away.
I don't know where he is. I can't wait all day. Sorry.
Can I leave him my number?
He's not going to call you.
Where is he?
I don't know.
An opportunity here.
Why am I waiting for you, Casey?
Sorry,
well, I can't hear you. What?
I'm sorry. I was doing some work in the other room. I didn't hear for a second.
All right. Well, can't somebody get you?
Yeah. They got me at the last minute.
All right.
Bro, what are you talking about?
A little curl in the middle of his forehead.
It's getting long. I need a haircut.
A lot of chicks digging you from the TV show.
Hey, that's beautiful, Howard. Thanks, brother.
Right.
Man.
Thanks, brother. He's got to be so manly.
He's weird because, like, he's a real good-looking guy, and I'm thinking, I never see him with a chick. He might be gay.
He's always doing that man stuff. Hey, dude, man, brother.
But he's a football player.
Yeah.
You might be gay.
You think so?
No,
yeah.
I don't think so.
A lot of people say that.
In this room.
Yeah, right.
Maybe that's why Jackie was chasing you.
He's got a gleam in his eye. Real good-looking guys are usually gay.
That's
true. He's a
maggot. They fall in love with their own image.
I don't know about that.
You banging anyone right now?
No, no, I'm not, Howard.
Wow, that doesn't make any sense.
No yeah. sense at all.
When's the last time you got laid?
I'd have to say probably be a month and a half.
You still sore?
Dude, you could go to any party walking in the way you look and get laid.
The intern. Yeah. There's a whole panel of interns here.
Robin, I like my job.
Oh, okay.
Howard, there's two things going on here. There's two things going on here, because I talk to Casey about this all the time, and I go, what are you doing this weekend? You know, you're going to get some? He's incredibly disciplined. During the week, he leaves here, he goes home, he eats, he works out, and he goes to bed.
Good. Okay, that makes sense.
Incredibly disciplined.
Nothing wrong with that.
And the second thing is, you know, Casey don't take just anybody.
Right.
He's, you know, I pointed out girls to him, and like, there was this girl intern a couple semesters ago. I thought she was pretty cute. She loved him. And he goes, I don't know, man, she's a little thick for me. And she really was.
Really?
You know, but so Casey's got a high standard.
He sounds 100% gay.
isn't that Ralph? Yeah. Ralph is always saying that.
Because you know what's going on in Casey's head? It's like, oh, no, they want to set me up with another girl. I'll have to find something wrong with
her. I have to have another excuse for why I don't want to go out with
her. It's always the same thing wrong with
her, too. No. Everyone's asking me why I'm not with a girl. I'll have to go out with one just to make it look good.
How do I cover it up?
You know, now that you mention this, he did do something that's really funny. He showed me a picture of a girl that he was thinking about dating that was on a calendar.
Right.
But maybe he just grabbed a calendar and told me that.
Oh, come on.
This calendar, I could show it to Gary and he'll think I'm into girls.
I'll pick this picture of a girl I don't know and talk about her.
I've seen heterosexual men look at calendars and pine away for girls, and maybe that's what I'll do.
I study it.
Right.
I study it. I'm no homo, I gotta tell you.
Really?
Wait a minute,
I'm really not.
The guy who called in from his gym and said Casey just stands around looking at everybody, and who's there but guys?
He's just comparing himself.
You see, Howard, I don't go out much, so I don't really meet a lot of women.
I don't.
You know what else is wrong with him? He's a really nice guy when it comes to women.
Yeah.
Because this girl I was telling you about that liked him, she introduced him to a bunch of her friends, and then she went away for a month.
Yeah.
And the friends all gave him the number and said, hey, call me while she's gone. So I said, are you going to call her? Mm. Are you going to call her friends? And he goes, I don't think it's right to call her friends while she's not around.
Is he gay?
I said, you should be over there banging every one of her roommates.
Oh. Right. You might be gay, dude.
Has she got a brother?
I might. No young man. How old are you, dude?
I'm 23.
Yeah. Man, at 23, I had no conscience. I don't have a conscience at 44.
Self-control.
Yeah.
What
your hormones,
that?
Howard, at 23, your hormones wouldn't let you stay in on
that's the weekend.
What
I'm
please.
Saying. You should be running wild.
If some chick gave me the number for all her friends, that would be it. What is it, Benji? Uh-oh, Benji. Oh. Benji only wishes he looks like Casey.
I do.
Well, dude, you could stop eating for you could skip a meal. Yeah. Maybe you'll look a little bit.
Casey inside I got a, Benji.
I got a funny Casey gay story.
All right, go ahead.
All right. I don't want to say her name, but it's a hot girl that it's definitely a really hot girl. It was after this party that everyone here went to. We went to her house, me and KC. We were going to crash at her house. And she said, like, well, one of you guys can stay in the bed because she only had one bed and everything. And so I was like, oh, that's cool. I'll do that. And she's like, well, I think you snore, so maybe better if KC did.
Oh. Right. Yeah, gee.
So,
gee, look at Benji, look at KC. Which one would you put in bed with you?
But she is, like, she's, like, model hot.
So she said, oh, one of you could stay in the bed, but not you.
Right. So I go in the shower, and I come out, and Casey's left.
Yeah, I did leave. I did. Like, even if something was going to happen, which it wouldn't because this girl is a friend. Right,
but she's model hot, right?
Yeah, she's very hot, but we wouldn't screw around.
Yeah, okay.
I wouldn't do it with Benji in the room.
You wouldn't?
No,
I would.
You would.
I was hoping they would.
Benji's sitting there the whole time
Benji
wishing.
Was hoping they would.
Benji's wishing that he could get in the bed with her.
Actually, I wanted Benji. That was
yeah, that was it.
Big joke.
Benji, you wish you could look like Casey. Yeah. Hey, Benji wishes he could look like Baba Booey.
Dress for shit.
Why don't you get in shape, man? You're a young man.
I'm going to. Yeah.
You're not a bad-looking guy. You're just fat.
Yeah, I know.
How much weight have you put on since you've been with us?
Probably about 50.
But why with us? Like, how come you were thin when you got here?
I wasn't thin when I got here. I was heavy. It's just like I've been putting.
Why don't you go to the gym with KC? He'll teach you how to do that.
All right, let's start working out, man.
But you know the funny thing about Benji is, like, he's like a homeless guy.
Right.
You think homeless guys would get thin?
Right.
But he never has anywhere to live.
Well, he eats some garbage pails. So what he does is he stores up as much food as he can.
Or you know maybe he doesn't have rent money because he's eating so much.
Now there's a fast food place I know now. You can eat. And if you say you don't love it, they give you another portion.
And then what you do, you go, I don't love this.
Yeah.
You know, every scam.
What place is that?
Okay, I said the name of Taco Bell.
Taco Bell lets you, if you say you don't love their buffet.
Yeah, it's the one on 59th and 3rd. And the girl gets so pissed at me. She goes, I'm not stupid. She goes, you've been here before. You know what you're doing.
Right.
You got to look at me. And I always say, well, I don't know who you are. And I act like, and she is, she's like,
hey, that's the rules. Yeah. If you don't love it.
And if I love it, occasionally it's really, really good, and I don't send it back and everything.
You look like you love everything.
Yeah, it looks like you don't love much. Oh, man. Or you don't hate much.
Something you don't love, you get another portion of. Yeah, that's right. Amazing.
Yeah, I don't love this. I want more.
Give me 10. They try to fight it, too, but I know.
What a weird slogan. If you don't love this, we'll give you more. Oh, that's too weird. In case you could get a lot of broads.
Yeah, Howard, I don't know.
And meanwhile, I'm looking at the name of the chick that you're talking about, Benji. Yeah. She's totally hot.
Yeah.
I'd be in bed with her in a second.
Well, he says she's a friend.
No, it would be weird. It would be weird. But Howard, you would do that with Benji in the room.
Yep. Yeah.
You would.
Oh, yeah.
I wouldn't
care if there
were.
I was in the
I wouldn't
care if there were
15
minutes.
Benjis in the room.
Casey, Howard, Casey, I haven't done that.
Can I say something?
Now, you don't know what I've done.
If I had
to. You told me you didn't. Remember with the girl and the guy and the girl and the guy?
Right. That was many years ago.
I'll tell you how.
And the girl to look like this girl.
Oh, if I had to. Oh. If I had to, I would do it with Benji as a partner.
Oh, you would.
I mean, like, I would let Benji be part of the action if I had to.
Yeah,
I don't think I could have got that with that girl. I don't think I could have had it.
Why don't you try? She wanted you in her bed.
It was a friendly thing.
Wait, which one of us did she says prefer
no,
in the
you
bed?
Stop.
So, dude, if it was friendly, why not just lay down in her bed with her and see what happens?
Because I had to go home. I had to be up in a couple hours.
If it was friendly, why
you think
would
I'm gay?
Say,
he had to go home and call his boyfriend.
Not Benji, you.
Yeah, she goes, one of you guys who sleep in my bed, but not Benji.
Well, I think I might understand that aspect, too.
Yeah, I mean, catch a hint. Yeah.
I'll prove that he's not gay.
How?
I'm sure you would.
He's not
by going out with him.
Are you sure you're real good looking? Because he's pretty particular. And you better have a penis.
You better be. You better be thin. And you better not have any facial hair. Right.
I don't have a penis. Sorry, Howard.
Describe yourself.
5'7". Size 6.
How much you weigh?
125.
125? Oh, that's too much.
That's too thick for KC.
Yeah, that's a little heavy.
You should start with me and everything.
5'7", 125. You should weigh 100.
Yeah. Well, remember, I'm Latin, so.
You got a nice ass?
Very nice.
All right, why don't you come? Where do you live?
I live in downtown.
Why don't you come over here today and we'll look you over?
I have to go to work.
Well, you want KC or not?
Yes, I want him.
Well, come down here. Let me look at you on your way to work. And then we'll decide if you can go out with him.
Okay, you'll decide?
Well, he'll decide, too.
Okay.
Well, we'll decide. All right, where is this?
40 West 57th.
Yeah. I'm over here at 40 West 57th.
Between 5th and 6th, a little closer to 6th.
It's 2 blocks west of Taco Bell.
This sounds like the girl from Taco Bell.
I was to you. I know what you're doing.
I'm not stupid.
No, but it's funny. When we're talking about KC, I talk to him a lot about stuff, and I often wonder... What, because you remember how you and I were talking
what
about
what does he
we
do
like
on the weekend?
No, but he really has a conscience. And
well, what's the last girl you went out with?
Well, if you can look, Howard, wait, I don't know if you can see it. You see a big knife that sticks right through here? There's been a couple of those, and that's why I have issues with women.
A knife through your heart?
Hurt him. Oh, my.
Yeah.
That's what every gay guy
does.
What did women do to him? Yeah.
What did a woman do to you? Broke up with you?
No, you know, just a whole bunch of bad things happened, you know, with a... I don't know.
What girl's going to break up with you?
You can't trust them.
Really?
That's
they hurt
not
you?
True.
You can't.
That's not true.
They hurt you?
Don't blame your past you know, problems on other women.
Then you must suck in bed.
No.
Dude, you know why? If a good-looking guy like you, seriously, I only wish I had your equipment and looked like you.
You're a sweetheart.
Dude, if I look like you and chicks were breaking up with me left and right, that means you suck in bed. You're not giving them an orgasm.
It wasn't a lot.
Do you give the girls the orgasm? Seriously.
Yeah.
You do.
Yeah. That's you know, you have to do it because if you don't do that, you'll never get it again. No, bro. Actually, Howard, I'm talking to somebody now. I'm talking.
Right.
I'm talking. Might have something on Thursdays.
Hey, but dude, once you sleep with them, it's over.
For me?
Yeah. Because.
You think I'm that lousy?
They're faking it, Casey.
Well, what? What happened?
Are you good looking? Yes. Are you a reasonably intelligent, nice guy? Yeah.
Thank you.
So what's the problem?
I don't know how to pick them. I don't know how to pick them. That's the thing.
Do you give them oral?
Let Howard pick them.
You don't do that?
I have to be in there for a long time. I have to be
Boyfriend for them.
Yeah. For
long Why?
Time. Why? Because that's you know that's where you can get a lot of stuff.
What?
No, you get more stuff from.
Yeah, it's just regular unprotected.
Yeah, who's training you?
You using a rubber?
Yeah, hell yeah. If, you know. Right. I'm so you're weird afraid about that.
You're weird about, like, but then they give you oral, right?
Well, just no complaints. There would be no complaints if that happened.
Oh, so you're going out with girls and they're not giving you oral?
No, no, no. The girls I went out with did, and that was good.
Oh, that was good?
Yeah. That's.
So when they do oral, you don't return the favor?
No, but you can do it other ways.
With what, your foot?
This big, thick football finger.
Yeah, right.
Oh, God.
Yeah, you're telling me that when you started just dating girls, you would go down there.
Oh.
Yeah. Right away.
Not the first night.
Not the first night, but...
You camp out there.
Second or third. If she's doing me, I'm doing her.
An hour the first night depends upon how much alcohol is involved.
Right. Let me tell you something. You go with a hot chick, and like she's well-groomed and really has it all together down there.
You have to know
that
hygiene.
That can be very pleasant.
You have to know the hygiene.
Yeah.
And once
but how do you ever know the hygiene?
You're thinking
too. You know, after a while, you know.
You know what, dude?
He's gay.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Heterosexual men don't.
I think so much.
Yeah, you're thinking way too much.
I do.
Sometimes you lose yourself and you just have to do it no matter what.
Three beers and you're
there's a landmine down there. You do it.
You know what else is going on with him?
What?
Like, you know when you have Cindy Crawford in here or any of the other supermodels and they talk about how in high school they weren't popular or they couldn't get dates? I mean, doesn't it ring hollow when Casey says, oh, I can't find the right girl? I mean, look at him.
Yeah.
And what is this hurting? Who's hurting him? I wonder what these girls did.
Yeah, what did they do? They cheated on you,
they
right?
Went out
well,
with
it was actually one time I dated this girl for a long time. And, you know, we had separated. I was in school. And I went home, so we weren't, you know, together for the whole thing. And then I knew something was up. You know what I mean? So then once that happened, then I went like a gangbuster and did a whole bunch of other stuff, and it was all done. You know what I mean?
What?
Well,
about a straight play.
So what you're saying is...
I was running the option, Howard.
We judge women first.
Your girlfriend cheated on you, so you went and cheated on her. Big deal.
Many times.
Dude, you're a young man.
No, but once that happens, then the trust thing is all done.
You left so what? The whole summer?
So, dude, what about dating? What about banging chicks and not worrying about it?
It's hard for you to understand now, but that girl you're talking about, never going to remember her again in 10 years. You know what I mean? Like, you're not going to get married. It's like, it seems important now, but in the scheme of things, it's nothing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I've already
happened to you.
Have what?
Girls dump you.
Yeah. All the time.
So what did it do? Nothing.
Made me go out and get more girls.
That's right.
Made me get married.
Oh.
I just had to have it.
Casey's going to do that.
What?
He'll walk in one day and he'll be married.
No.
Good luck, buddy.
He's not a healthy date.
When we were at John Scores party, all of a sudden Casey ducks down real quick. I'm like, Casey, what's wrong? And he's like, this girl's after me. It was like some stripper. And he didn't want her to see him and everything.
No.
Like, strippers were after him.
Gee, that's a horrible thing.
You know how you and I would kill if women were after us?
Yeah.
Casey actually has to avoid them.
That's not true. There's something going on here. What's going on?
I guess that story didn't happen. I'm sorry I imagined that story. That didn't happen.
No. No, Howard, I just don't go out during the week, so I don't run into
her. So, dude, you want to meet this chick over here on the phone?
I'll meet her.
All right.
You won't date her.
Honey, you going to get down here real quick?
I'm going
to
try.
Well, hurry up.
Are you? When you look in the mirror, do you see a 9 or a 10? Because that's what Casey's looking for.
Casey, is that what you're looking for?
I just have this one type I like.
What's that type?
It's not very, it's very small, petite. It's a guy.
Like
small,
Jackie.
Petite, blonde.
It's you're
me.
Blonde?
That's me.
It doesn't sound like
it's Jackie.
Honey, you think you could get him?
I could get him.
All right, come on down here. Hurry up. I'll hang up now.
All right, Howard.
All right, we're waiting for you.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll put you on hold so we can get your name. Hold on. All right. I got to see you, man. I tell you something.
He's restricting himself so much, there's no girl who can fit.
If I was Casey, man, I'd be banging every chick. I'd be banging you during the commercials.
I don't think you would, man.
You have to restrict yourself to... So you like a type, but there are other girls you like, too.
Yeah, but that's what I'm very attracted to. And it's, if I just find one little...
Get out of here. You're nuts.
Howard, I don't think...
Dude, you might have a problem.
Oh. I know
I think
we
ought to have him analyzed.
I don't think we need to.
Even if you're not... Yeah. Thank you.
You know the score, huh?
Please.
I think it's all too clear.
Oh, come on.
Wouldn't you just be banging everyone if you look like that?
I dream about what... If I could just have Casey's body for the weekend and jump in it,
right.
I would go like a madman. I would bring it back.
Of course. Of course.
Yeah, but look at it this way. You can't meet anybody through this show, you know? It's real tough to meet somebody if you work on the Howard Stern show.
Getting laid through this show.
It is hard to meet girls here.
50 cities. He's 23. Good looking.
There's a couple of good looking girls who work here. What about this... what is this? Some sort of promotions director or something that's good looking?
The redhead.
Wait, what's her story?
She lives with a guy.
Yeah. All right, big deal. You're so KC, right. You should be able to get her.
But there's a couple of girls back there that are single that are right up there for him.
Yeah.
I think I can get girls just with pictures of Casey on me.
Right.
Robin, I'm going to leave with you to meet him.
All right.
Howard, what did Robin mean when she just said even Gary was getting girls?
Yeah. Well, I'm saying Gary was getting
Gary
girls.
Get girls. Casey surely.
Gary, you're a lot uglier than Casey.
I know.
You're downright heinous. I mean, please.
What do you mean, what did I mean?
Yeah, Natalie, what is it?
Hey, I just want to let you know that I watched Saturday Night, and I was on the floor dying. I love it. You guys make me die.
Thank you.
And the only way I would have gotten through Saturday and Sunday, because, of course, I got dumped, you guys had me crying. I would have been crying as in sad instead of crying as in mad. And I just think the only thing that would get me through this is if you will let me come down as a physical therapist and give you a full body massage.
Hey, now.
Give me?
Yeah.
I'll take that.
Well, wait a minute. We need somebody to massage this lupus guy today.
Hey, yeah, can you massage this lupus dude, too?
Okay.
He's only got a couple of weeks to live. He needs a massage, too.
Uh-huh. Is this, like, today? Like,
yeah, today.
Boy, doesn't anybody work?
No.
Okay, what time?
10 minutes.
Like in 10 minutes?
In 10 minutes.
Where are you?
I'm in Brooklyn.
Yeah, hurry up. Get down here.
Get here as soon as you can.
Quick.
Okay.
Just, you know, don't even get dressed.
So right. It's only going to be him? I mean...
No, me too. I can use a little rub down.
And you too.
Oh, okay. Yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. What are you talking about, full body massage?
I'm talking about the whole thing. Feet, hands, fingertips, neck.
Yeah.
Never mention the thing you're looking for.
And what other thing you got in mind?
What other thing?
Yeah. There's a lot of parts of the body that don't get massaged.
So are you going to, like, lay out in a full table?
Mm-hmm.
With a towel on?
Yeah, that's what I plan on doing.
Yeah?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, baby.
It's like I go up the thigh. It's like, you know, my fingertips get up a little high.
I don't care. That sounds good to me. I'm like a volcano ready to explode.
Because I need to get over this. It's really bad.
You a white girl?
Yeah.
All right.
Italian.
Oh, white girl, Robin.
Italian.
Uh-huh.
Howard, would I ruin it for asking for height and weight?
How high? How? What's your height?
I knew that was coming.
How high are you?
Lupus. Huh? I work with those patients.
How much you weigh?
130.
How high are you?
Oh, how tall.
She better be 7 feet.
No. I'm Italian. We got big butts.
How tall are you?
5'7".
Ooh. Mm. That could be hit or miss.
Yeah.
You better have 3 butts. Are you really in good shape?
Yes, I'm a physical therapist. I'm into exercise.
All right. All right, hurry up down here. Hold on.
57th, right?
Yeah. I don't know.
40 West 57th.
Okay.
Okay.
Jog here. Hold on.
I just want to say hi to Agnes on the phone.
All right, hold on. Things are looking up. All right, I got to take a break. Casey, you might be gay.
You think so?
When is he going to wake up otherwise?
Okay. No offense, man.
But don't you have a little, like, a type that you like, that you go for?
Yeah, anything with a vagina. That's the type.
I don't know, man.
You got a vagina, I like you.
He's picky. I have to say he's picky.
Please, do you have a type? I mean, seriously.
Yeah.
Even if you have a type,
all limbs and a vagina.
Yeah. I was talking to this girl the other day, and I said, oh, you only like these, like, you know, big, like, husky guys. She goes, yeah, the last guy I dated was a big husky guy.
Yeah.
She goes, but I like, you know, there's all kind of things I like.
Oh, there's exceptions, course there's exceptions.
You go on dates and you meet other people.
I have a type under optimum conditions.
Right.
I'll take anyone.
Right, exactly. Yeah, I mean, put 50 people, I can tell you which is most attractive.
In a pinch.
You know, someone said, you like blondes or brunettes? I'm like, what? Who even notices?
Robert
cares about their hair.
Right.
Robert saw
shave their heads.
Robert saw what I was capable of in a pinch.
Right. All right, I got to take a break. We'll come back. There's tons of people on the phone. We got a very busy show today. The guy who's dying is coming in. Bill Maher from Politically Incorrect is coming in.
Why is he coming in?
I don't know. We decided to have him in.
Yeah, but why did he... I don't understand that.
He wanted to come in.
He wanted to come in. That's what I don't
He
know.
Wants to be here. So let him be here. Yeah. Who cares? We can ignore him.
Sure, let him just sit there. We'll talk to each other.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And Casey, seriously, the reason a woman would break up with you, because there's no reason for a woman to break up with you, is that you're not satisfying her sexually.
No, I think it's because I'm mental.
Why are you mental?
I'm mental.
Look, why?
I have problems.
What is your problem?
Somehow relating to these people, I guess, sometimes.
These people.
You have a hard time relating to women?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because he likes guys.
No, because he's a guy and he's not that bright.
He likes guys. I bet you hang out with guys and you like him.
Yeah. He's one of the, you know what? He's like that. He's like Mark McGuire. He's got to get in touch with his emotions.
He's an athlete guy.
Right.
Can I ask Casey a question? I'm just really curious. Cause it's been 6 weeks since you've had sex. Do you play with yourself every day?
Oh, jeez.
Bench.
No, I'm curious.
What do you want to know, bro?
No, I'm really... answer the question.
Do you take care of your own needs?
Oh, of course. Right. What? I'm a guy.
Are you as particular with that as you are with, like, in real life?
Only in particular.
I can just see him, like, starting to have a fantasy and, like forget about it and stuff.
No, there's always one that you come back to, man. We're talking about it.
That's a good one.
There's always one you come back to, somebody said
that. Button.
With you, is it a guy or a girl?
It's Jackie.
Tell us truthfully, have you ever been attracted to a guy?
No, I swear. I hate body hair.
Oh.
Guys are hairy, and I hate that.
That's a gay thing to hate body hair.
Please. Come on. That's enough of this discussion.
It's not a gay thing.
Come on. We got better things to discuss.
But it's a gay thing not to have it.
Hey, the Jets won, but they'll lose next week.
But I thought they were going to lose yesterday.
Did you?
From all the talk, I didn't even watch the game. I thought, I don't want to see them lose to Miami.
HBO had a really good fight on Saturday night.
The Chavez fight?
No. It was this 21-year-old black guy.
Oh, I missed the first fight.
Yeah, that was the good one.
Yeah?
He was 21 years old, and everyone was saying his father pushed them into fighting and all this stuff. And he's 21 years old, and he was way too young to be fighting this very seasoned professional Puerto Rican guy.
Right.
And they started fighting the 21-year-old guy. They just beat the hell out of him.
Ew.
They had to stop the fight.
Well, the other fight was pretty good, too. The guy's mouth got all bloody.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah, they had crap hanging off his lip, like wax.
Nice.
Yeah.
It was cool. HBO has some good fights. See what I did all weekend. Watch TV.